Oi! Wake up! Wake up! Wake up, you fools!
you didn't turn yours on?
I got it now.
Oh, your green screen is freaking out too.
I didn't do it.
Oh.
See that? Chroma key. Chroma key make her more solid, like that. Make Jin more solid. What's up, gang? Zug Zug.
Say well, huzzah, huzzah. I'll just say throw
back Confurioso with a sub right out of the gates, my friend. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Welcome. Getting Friday started off right. Hello, everybody.
Hello, everybody.
What's going on for science? Assassin, Gnozel, welcome back. Andrew loves Rome. What's happening? Bray, Cybound, what's happening, peoples? Grins, what's going on? Your week of Mondays has come to an end, I remember. Pixel Hobo Snake, I see you guys. What's happening out there? Resurrected Ray, Sailor Jeff.
What is Zug Zug?
Big Bobzilla! Zug Zug was the thing for screwing that they did in the Caveman movie. The Ringo Starr. And okay, who else was in that movie? Pixel Hobo. That's ancient. That's like our kid time movie. Like one of those
I asked him, Snakeman, while I was doing it, I said, how much am I getting paid for this?
What's going on?
And it was just crickets. So.
Fidgety Hunter Hill, what's going on?
Still waiting.
We're not listening to, don't listen to Jen right now. Kev Rob, what's happening? Somebody named Gentastic8 in the chat, taking up space. What the hell? Sniper Bob, Samurai
yes,
Med Marcus.
Uncle Touchy.
Samurai named Marcus, what's going on? Uncle Touchy, brunch Sunday. Yeah, I know. She's already in. She, like, she got mad at me because I made a Moscow Mule. Beep. Cheers.
You
I made a Moscow Mule.
Austin
I didn't ask her if she wanted one. What's happening, everybody? Welcome to the weekend. This is officially the weekend now, I think. Fridays, we get to start at 5. And since we're on the West Coast, we know that at least everybody in the U.S. is already off. Or should be off. Or close to off. Ray coming in with a fiver. Thank you so much, Ray. Exclamation point hype in chat.
I am paid with love, which I guess is... priceless, so.
What's that? You get paid with love.
Yes.
I don't even. That's why I didn't answer you earlier. Because I feel like I am the one who is in a tough spot because you don't seem to remember that you get paid with love. Oh, gosh. It's going to be one of those nights, people. Desired death. What's going on? What's happening, everybody? So it is the weekend. We're going to start off Friday. I don't know what the hell we're doing. I do know what the hell we're doing. We actually have a plan again today. And it is based off of some things that people have been asking about during the week. Doing black armor panels. Doing some OSL. Doing pre-highlighting without an airbrush. So the title of the stream says, no airbrush, no problem. We're going to go with that being the theme today. And what we're going to be working on is this guy. Anybody remember this guy? Came out around 4th edition time with Space Marines. It's the old chaplain from when the Black Templar stuff came out.
You trade your passion for glory.
Got him all built.
Don't lose your grip on the dreams of the past.
He's saying the lyrics to Eye of the Tiger, by the way.
What? Eye of the Tiger? Say what? Is that what Ray did?
Well, I only see the first few words, but...
Yeah.
I recognize those first
words
as
Adeptus Artemis.
Sniper Bob with $10.76. Thank you, my friend. Sniper Bob, the man. Thank you. What's that? Going to be painting Tyranids for a while, Pixel? I think that's the way it goes with those armies. Orcs and Tyranids, you're always painting them for a while. Right? Are they gluten-free miniatures?
We like the gluten around here.
We're not afraid of bread. We ain't afraid of bread here, so
bring on that gluten.
I would say no.
From Sniper Bob 76.
I would say no.
Let's rock this Friday. Swoop, 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 swoop,
swoop,
your mama.
Swoop, your mama. Oh, God. It's beginning. It's beginning. Post office lost your Warsenal order, but confirmed it arrived 2 weeks ago. You're not struggling to avoid losing your mind. So Warsenal you ordered and the post office lost it. I feel like lately the post office is literally the worst institution on the planet. We've been lucky But the one package that we have sent that has had a problem in the entirety of the stream was the most expensive package to the most expensive place we could have shipped it to, the most expensive method it could have gone, and it's lost in the warp. And they can't even tell us it was ever delivered. They can't tell us where it ever went. Some people say it's still here in Arizona, and some people say it made it to Australia. So we have no idea, and they don't want to seem to handle the problem. So yeah, I feel your pain right now. Trust me. That's been going on since literally January or February, too, by the way. Boil the hell out of it. We've heard that one, man!
You have to be very careful with the jokes, because we've heard pretty much all of them,
I was going to say, I think we're getting to the end of bad dad jokes.
Didn't think it was.
And I'm not old enough for my memory to be that decrepit to where I can't remember the bad dad jokes from way earlier. So, gotta be careful. Can't be pulling that shit all the time. Two packages lost. Non-painted minis. Hopefully Desire Death that they weren't painted minis from like a commissioner or something. That would be horrible. A bad grandfather joke. Do grandfathers even bother telling jokes?
What is happening right now?
Oh my God. What is this? Who let you in here? Was there a sign on the door that said no hobos?
Twitch took your sign down.
Oh my God, it's hard to find good help these days.
It is almost impossible.
What's happening, yo,
having a fun day. We painted a lot of things. Did a lot of work in progress gallery. Did some marble. Literally, we did everything today. I feel like we just did little pieces of multiple projects today.
Are you lying to me? Did you actually do a lot of painting, or did you do a lot of shuffling models around?
A lot of moving models around. taking a long time. Oh, not this color. Wait, this color.
Maybe over here. We are pros at the illusion of painting here on the Longmore Network.
But yeah, we have a lot of new people in chat I haven't seen before. People asking like, oh, how long you guys gonna be painting? We don't ever stop. So.
Oh, yeah. I noticed this is Jason. In chat today. Lots of good questions coming around. Lots of new faces. We always love to see that, man. Fridays are a great day. The weekend's starting. We're about to get kicked off over here. We're going to paint some old legendary freaking GW Chaplin tonight.
Oh, my God.
Maybe not quite legendary, but fairly old. Like 4th edition Black Templar sprue type Chaplin age. It's still the metal style. He's still a metal dude.
Is it the one with the big hand or the big or the
Chrysarius? No, it's the dude with the plasma pistol.
Word.
Skull face with the rivet mohawk and the plasma pistol and Crozius. Yeah, we're gonna do
that. Is it like the super thick handled Crozius that's like over the top thick or?
Oh yeah. Yeah, it's bigger than his neck, I think.
Yeah, it's so clutch. This is Jason Craze and Gentastic. I believe I heard her back there.
She's here.
She's here. Slow Phones Gaming. Hey, what's up? The Rembrandt girl? Of pro painting.
What's up, girl?
What's up, girl? So we're about to get this thing going, guys. We're going to host these people. Jump over to their stream. Wait for the host to go through. Blast them with emotes. Kick back, relax. I guarantee you're going to learn some high-level shit here in the next few hours,
oh,
guys.
Oh, God, the pressure is real. That means I actually have to paint.
You do. You can't do what I just did for 3 hours.
Setting me up for failure, man. That's not good. Bridges with delight. That's not good. Jack of Clubs, thank you for the sub. Yeah, everybody, come on over. Make sure you head out of Kenny's chat and over here to us so you can take part in the wonderful conversation and painting. We'll see you in a minute. Thanks, my man.
Love you, pimps.
All right. So let's get this show on the proverbial road. And like I said, welcome, everybody. Hope everybody's weekend is off to a good start. Or if you work on the weekends and you're off all week, you bums, I hope you have a lot of work in front of you. There you go. I said it.
Desire Death, did you already send him a message and you want him to respond? I don't understand this.
If you sent me a message, I will respond. But if you haven't, I don't think I've got a message from you. Desire. Are we dealing with Canada Post? A lot of times I am technically dealing with Canada Post as it has to go through there before it gets to where it's supposed to be. All you freaking Canadians.
Hey, Elric. Yes, that was my job of the day.
But I'll serve you, but don't start anything. That's horrible. By the way, jumper cables don't drink. I know this for a fact. Most of the jumper cables I've hung out with in my life are not big drinkers. Just going to say it that way. Tim the Great, what's going on, man? Or Pride, thanks for the host. Old Navy based jokes. Old Navy, like the store?
That I thought too.
You're painting one of the old Orlok Necromunda models? Those are horrible, by the way. What's going on, Elric? Good to see you, my man. Year of Shorty, what's going on? Take off on the Canadian stuff. Take off, eh?
Desire Death, my next question is...
Take off, eh? Kilty, thanks
for
bits.
Where did you send this message?
Yeah, I don't know, Desire. No response. Really? You sent me a message? Through what? Resend it. That's all I gotta say.
Well,
if I missed it, I apologize.
If it was to email, just make sure everything was spelled correctly, because maybe he didn't...
Yeah, I don't remember having anything from you, so... If I didn't answer, it means I never saw it. I don't ignore people. All right, so tonight we're going to do some pre-highlighting again, but we're going to do it without an airbrush. So we're going in hot, and we're going to show everybody how to do the kind of style of painting that you see around here, but without the airbrush, because I know a lot of people either aren't confident in their airbrush skills or don't own an airbrush. Either way, that's fine. But they always ask, how can I get that similar technique or style of painting that I see you do so often if I don't have an airbrush? And I always am honest and say, well, it's not going to be 100% the same. Airbrushes have a way of blending through aerosol that is very, very fine misted spray, and you can't reproduce that with a brush no matter how hard you try. But you can get very close. And so what we're going to do today is do a little bit more of a, I would say more of a textured style of paint, because it's all going to be brush stroke, doing armor panels and things like that, as opposed to like yesterday when we were painting up our Morat, our Suryat, with heavy rocket launcher. We got him going. I did a little bit of red and some accents on the black and stuff after the stream, just to lay some more color to figure where my next steps were going to be with him. But we started with just a pre-highlighted model, basically just black primer, white misted over it to give us our bright spots and dark spots, and then airbrushing the browns over that. And then I went back and cleared up all of my black areas, like underneath the shoulder pads on the arms, the hair, the gun, you know, all of that. So there's no more of the brown overspray anywhere. Did a little bit of non-metallic work on like the hip panels and things like that to get them to be kind of a dull gray metal. Same with the boots, like the toe of the boot there, and start setting that up for getting to the finish line. Not gonna do a whole lot of work on that guy though. I was just kind of testing out a color scheme yesterday. So that's kind of the look that we're going for. Obviously different colors, but smooth transients, nice light application, get your values set right on the model, but without an airbrush, okay? So I'll always say it is more difficult. It does take more time, but it's definitely just as rewarding if you get the technique down. And so what I did is, this is an old Chaplin model, like I said, from back in the day when the Black Templars were coming out. I dug him out of a chest here. And primed in black, and then gave him a misting with the Army Painter matte white base primer. Okay, so this is just your standard white primer, consider it. Right? Resurrected coming in with a fiver. Thank you so much, my friend. All right, you're over the top nostalgic for the old chunky GW look. I don't mind some of this. I just... You know, I can't lie. Like, when this came out, I was like, oh, hell yeah, because these were like some of the best Space Marines ever released when they came out. As times progress, you get to where you're like, no, I really like my guys to look a little bit more realistic as far as like sizing and stuff. So the chunkiness is a little lost on me, but I still love it. So you won't hear me bitching about it.
For new and terrible jokes, by the way.
Terrible jokes. Damn it. So we're going to be working on this guy, Chaplin. A lot of black armor, which is another thing that all comes up often around here. How do I get a good look on my black armor using that pre-highlight method that I use? So we're going to work on that today. I haven't figured out what color we're going to do for the shoulder pads yet. Maybe green. I don't know. Maybe we'll make him like a dark angel. Although I think their guys would have robes on. So we'll figure something out for the shoulders. Yeah, so pre-highlight. So the first stage is just going over it with just your white primer, but you're not trying to get more than just a sprinkling of paint on the model, because as you'll see, let's zoom in here, right? Look at how primer acts, right? Primer out of the can, no matter where you live, gives you a very harsh speckling on your model, right? There's just no way to do it because you're dealing with a shitty nozzle on a shitty paint can. Just plain and simple. I don't care who makes the paint. I love Army Painter. I love those guys to death. But a spray paint and a big can is a spray paint and a big can. You can't change it no matter what nozzle you put on it. It's always going to spatter. The control of the spray is non-existent, so you're just left with a situation where you have to be very, very careful. And, you know, we're up really close here, and you can still see kind of the speckling effect that we get from that spray can. So we don't want to spend a lot of time putting paint on this model, otherwise we build up way too much texture with the can. So what it is it's just a very light dusting so that we can kind of get the angle of light on the model and a setup for where you need to go with your brush and your white and gray paints. Make sense? It is a good cheater method. So if you're concerned at the beginning and learning how to do this of, okay, how do I represent the angle of lighting on the model? Well, just going very quick over it with the spray paint. I mean, literally press the button, get the paint coming out way over here, and then just swoop it over the top of the model real quick. Don't get too close. Just go past it real quick to get this light dusting. Rotate the model around 180 degrees and do it again across the back. Bam. And this is what you get. Right, so it's not a lot of white on there, you know, just a little bit of spotting. If you go too heavy on it, then you're going to get texture and it's going to drive you nuts. But it shows you where you should be highlighting. Top of the knee came through, the folds on the tabard came through, or the scroll that is his tabard. Obviously, top of the head, top of the shoulder, crochets, hands. You get that detail picked out because you just swipe it in one angle right across the kind of the top and maybe 30 degrees off center over the top of the model. So it's very, very quick and easy. Don't feel like you got to go back over it and put a lot of white. You'll wind up with a model that's just that has way too much brightness on top, and it's going to be very hard to work with after that, right? And so now we're just going to start in and start brushing. And I'm going to drink lots. One of them was assaulted, resurrected. That's horrible. No, Strats, what's going on? Your vote is salamanders? A salamander's chaplain? We can do that. I don't have room on this guy really to do anything with a logo for the salamanders, but we could do the dark green, right? Maybe do the flames on the shoulder? Is that what you guys are wanting? We could do that. We could paint the flames on this shoulder with the green, and then just do this one over here in just green with the studs, like gold studs or something. I like that idea. Do all of the trim in gold. I'm okay with that. We'll do that. Resurrected, you're winning. Show us the 90s heavy metal dry brush at all. Oh, here we go. Paint, wash, dry brush. Done. Or can't get their airbrush to super low output like I do. Just the control. Well, that's why I say confidence in the airbrush is just about control. Feathering it, being able to get enough of that detail so you can get fine spots out. You don't wind up oversaturating certain areas of the model. I mean, you can get in and do just a highlight on the chest and spot highlight on the arm and things like that. So yeah, as you're building that confidence with your airbrush, sometimes it's easier to kind of just take a step back, use your airbrush for priming. I feel like using the airbrush for this pre-highlight is perfect because it gives you a very smooth transition. It's an easy method to do, so I show it repetitively. But for those people who just are afraid of their airbrush or don't have one, this is why we're doing this tonight.
Trainwrecks, enter our raffle. It costs absolutely nothing.
Nothing.
And you could win some cool stuff that will help you start painting. Trainwrecks said, I love your stream. I don't paint, but it's something I've always found fascinating. You make me want to pick up some stuff to start, but alas, money is tight.
Exactly, Trainwrecks. Friday is a good day to be here because we do our treasure trove giveaway, which literally comes with paints, brushes, and models. Like literally everything you need to get started. That happens at the end of the stream. You got to be here for it, but hang out. You could wind up walking home with everything you need to do to get started. Elric, thank you so much for the 10 spot. All right, let's do some painting. Let me get this damn can of primer out of my face. Get out of here, primer. Okay, I feel like I want to start, because we're doing black armor, I'm going to start with a black gray on this. Whereas with the airbrush, you can go in with just pure white and thin it way down. And as you go lightly over it, you get a natural gray, right? So this model being pre-highlighted with the airbrush, you see we transition from black in the deepest recesses, but we start getting up to a black gray and then a medium gray and then finally white at our brightest spots, right? So we can get more work done with one color of paint and just a little bit more effort with the airbrush side. So it is a lot quicker to do this. It gets you to the point where you can be painting details and stuff a lot quicker. It's one of the main reasons why I tell everybody an airbrush is a superior tool in the long run for getting you to the part where you start brush painting. It speeds up the beginning process. But like we said, you can do anything without it, right? Just understand what you've got here to recreate with the brush. We can't do this with just white paint. You can, it's just gonna take you forever if you glaze white from so thin that it's really just a dark gray. A lot easier to just go in with a dark gray. So we're gonna use the black gray RLM from Model Air, which, by the way, Jen, the super trooper that she is, put all the Model Air in the rack today. And I got all the Model Air on the website. I don't know how we messed that roll up. I should have been loading the rack and you should have been typing all the stuff in, because I was going bonkers typing all the stuff in.
You did a good job.
217 paints. None of them have their graphics along with them yet. I didn't have time to do that, but they are all up on the website. So Model Air is up there. The game paints are not up there yet, but they are coming. So hold tight. But we are trying hard to get all the Vallejo up on the store. Slowfusegaming.com, for those of you that aren't aware, we do have a web store where we sell all the things that we use here on the stream. All right, and now what we're going to start doing is glazing on...
Is it store?
Gray.
Store, right?
Yeah, I think so.
Yep. Steiny said, I bought some white and black Master's Touch tube acrylic today.
Nice.
Was it Golden Brand Airbrush Medium you used?
Yes. Yep, I use Golden Airbrush Medium, although you can use the Liquitex. I just prefer the Golden. Golden's a better product. But if you have, if your local store or wherever you buy from only has the Liquitex, it's just fine.
Cydrian said, I got my army painter paints in today. Excited to see how I like the line.
Nice. What I'm doing is I'm taking this dark gray color that we're going to be using here.
Hey, somebody likes us.
Gork! What's going on?
Numbers.
Do we have Mork as well? Gork and Mork? And I'm going to start with the dark gray from all these darker areas where I still have black showing, and I'm just going to lightly feather it up and not cover the white, but just kind of blend it up towards the area of the white, like there on the knee, and on this backside. Very lightly bringing up the gray. Leave the white peaked where it is. You don't want to cover the white with the dark gray. It kind of defeats the whole purpose of what we're doing here. But again, kind of bring it in on the inside of this thigh.
You gonna put any secret weapon stuff on the store?
Yes. As soon as they are back in stock, then the answer is yes. Oh, show. The big thing to be paying attention at this point in time is how your white that fell from the can, in this case, how it's laying on the model, right? So like on this knee, bright at the top of the knee and then feathers out a little, because of the angle that I chose, it's a little heavier to the left than it is to the right. So I'll do a little bit more of the dark gray over to the right. The inside of the greave here is obviously darker towards the tabard and crotch area. So we'll put a little bit more of the gray black there and feather it out as we come around to the front.
No stress, we will ship wherever you pay us to ship.
Yep, worldwide, my friend.
Shipping rates are on there for...
And it's real-time calculated shipping rates, so it actually, wherever you put your address, it gives you the current real-time rates for getting stuff to you. So we don't try to make any money. There's no handling fees or anything like that. Shipping is what shipping is. It's the only fair way to do it. Because it is expensive. As much as they screw up, the post office likes to charge you an arm and a leg to do so these days. The key here is just basically going through and painting the model as if it were a black and white movie. Right? Very, very thin with the paint. Feathering it up over that pre-highlight.
Get down with the clown!
Down with the clown!
That was from Ray Silver.
You are talking about the nonsensical raving
not psychotic
of a lunatic
gesture.
Mind.
Hashtag not psychotic gesture. I'm just picking my dark spots, feathering out of the dark spots over to the light, and pick the left, go over to the right where that white fell from the spray can, underneath of this grenade, everywhere that you can think, from the underside of the upper torso, where it falls into shadow, and just blend a
that
little bit across
that
line.
That dog is subtle as a hand grenade in a barrel of oatmeal.
Where the white starts to show up a little bit more. You're not trying to turn the model gray, all right? Notice how thin the paint is that I'm putting on. It doesn't hardly leave any color on my skin. But what it'll do is help ease that transition there from the spray can being so heavy and leaving that kind of chalky almost nature that spray cans do. You bring the gray out of the black. Up into just a hair of that white. Then you'll help to create a nice setup for a blend later on.
Frankie Figgs said, I remember hearing you play Infinity in the Arizona area. You play with the MayaCast crew or
I do.
Difference?
Yep, I do. Yep, we had Tom Shadle on the stream here for our 5,000 follower stream, doing a lot of teaching on Infinity. That is the group that I play with here local. Tom, Kip, all that motley bunch.
Hey, somebody likes us.
Hey, thank Scooper. You for the follow.
Explore.
Scooper. And again, just on the back, coming in on the greaves, making sure I get a little bit of gray transitioning over into the white. Just repetition is all we're talking about here.
Ray wants to know when Tom's coming back for a revenge game with you.
Revenge game? He didn't play me at all. What are you talking about? I did beat him once. Only once, though. Maybe I've only beat him once during the
did he play the day tournament. That he was here, or was he just...
No, he was just coaching.
Okay.
Yeah, we weren't.
Desire Death said, looking at a pistol trigger airbrush, would you recommend the Grex or the Neo Iwata for general purpose?
Oh, boy. That's a tough one, right? Because I love all of those. Grex is the superior product as far as construction. It's a better built airbrush. It will last you a lot longer, I can tell you that. You've watched me use the Neo here on stream for the better part of 8 months, though. And, you've seen all the work that I'm able to do with it. So I would be remiss if I said, you know, not to use it, right? Notice how this gray here, it's more evident on the shoulder pad, how as I'm taking the gray and blending it up into the white from the shadows, that it's helping to give me a smoother transition. It's covering up a lot of that speckled edge that comes from that white on the spray paint. That's exactly what we're going for.
Uncle Touchy versus Ugly Jen.
Why don't you donate $5 to the
It was, right? It was Uncle Touchy
Thanks.
Versus Ugly
Thank
Jen,
you.
Actually. 669, the great ant of the beast. Thank you, Camo Specs. How the hell are you today? Again, I'm just letting that, the way the spray paint fell on the model, act as a cheat sheet to show me where to put my shadows. Right? And so I'm putting up, like, right here in the recesses as I go towards the skull under those chains. Darken that up a little bit.
$6.69 donation. Frankie Pig said, that's awesome. I'm just getting into the game myself and briefly met Tom up here at Twinfinity.
Nice. Oh, nice. See you in the Minnesota area. Fantastic. Yeah, I knew he was up there.
Twinfinity was happening in the Twin Cities.
Yep. Twinfinity in the Twin Cities. Yeah, we are...
Pretty smart sometimes.
We have talked about doing a WOTAN deal with Tom and Kip here in the studio, but it's been tough, I guess, for everybody to figure out their schedules and make it come to pass, but we're still working on that, so hopefully we'll see some progress on that in the near future. I'd love to see a WOTAN battle report that we could do here in the game lab. And get them in both involved. Both great proponents of the game, do a hell of a lot for the community, and good guys.
Ray, I probably won't paint until Jason is more caught up on his commission. He needs the time. Instead of taking the time to teach me, he needs time to work himself.
Yeah.
We'll get there someday.
We keep talking. There are so many things we've got coming, and it's just like, wow, time. That wonderful thing called time. Chewing us up right now. Spitting us out. All good stuff, though. We're not complaining. Store's doing really well. You guys are being huge supporters on here. No complaints. A little bit of gray right around
Desire said, Grex, if you want quality or the Iwata for a slightly cheaper option.
Yeah, the Iwata is going to give you great value for the money. I feel like the Grex is still a fantastic brush. You don't see me use it as much here. As long as my Neos are still pounding out, you know, the good work, then I haven't felt like I needed to use them as much. The Grex, that is. Because I still am just trying to find the limitations of the Iwata, and I have not gotten there yet. And I know, as odd as that sounds for a fairly inexpensive brush, I think retail technically on it is supposed to be like $150-$160. I've been able to find them at like $105. I think we've misreported that you're able to get them at like $80 from some of the hobby stores. I think that's that was a minimal thing that was only available for a while because they had them mispriced. They had them priced along the same lines as the non-pistol grip Neo. But most places I know, Hobby Lobby, I think, figured all that out, and now they've got it priced correctly. So I think about $105 for the Neo is where you're at. That's still a lot less than the $289, $300 that you normally will find.
And you can still always get 40% off something regular price.
The Grex. Yeah, but I think even with the 40% off, I think it's like $100, $105. We were thinking that they were like at around $100 and that you could get it for like $75. Gotcha. That was because they had it priced incorrectly. If your Hobby Lobby still does, jump on it. But most of them, I think, have changed the pricing on it.
You have a 75% off coupon at Hobby Lobby, Ray? Where do you get that?
Where the hell does that come from?
You only get 40.
A good one. Getting all these dark areas down around the ear. Cheeks. I don't have to do too much reinforcement. Cool. The black is pretty good on here, so I feel like that's pretty good on the model. Drags those shadows up, gives me a little bit of mid-tone. Best place to see is how it's working on that shoulder pad right there. The shoulder pad is deep black here, but you can start seeing the gray come along, and then we start coming up into that lighter white area. Same thing where it starts fuzzing the blends to where we come up white on the shoulder, across the breastplate here, on the head, things like that, right? You can see here towards the back of the head where I've dropped a little bit of the dark black in there. The dark gray, dark black. All right, now we're gonna move up to a mid-tone gray, and if I can find it.
Desire, I think only Hobby Lobby because you can always get 40% off when there.
They've always got a weekly coupon. So
I don't know that they're better than another place to purchase it, but if you've got that coupon, it's.
We're gonna use uniform gray for this. It has a little bit of a blue. I'm gonna do a little bit of a glaze of blue on the black armor at the very end, so that's fine. Make me one with everything. What? Why does that have, the Buddhist to the hot dog vendor said, make me one with everything?
Make me one.
Oh, make me one with everything. Oh, I got it. I got it. A little slow on the uptake.
Why don't you donate $5 to the cause and maybe it'll make you feel better.
Michael, are you kidding me? Literally just comes in here and is like, hey, what's up, folks? Boom! And drops a hundo.
Wow.
Like, legit walks through the door, owns the place, and drops a hundy. Michael, everybody, exclamation point hype in chat for this man. Absolutely destroying the stream this week. Holy hell. How the hell are you? He's like, guess who's back? He's like, here's Johnny.
Are you saying his name right?
Yeah, I asked him. I said Michael.
Oh, it's Michael? Okay.
Or it could be Mika or Micah Ilmodi. I don't know.
Yeah,
we're going with Michael.
That seems like. We just call him Mike.
Just Mike. Mike, you humble me, my friend. Holy hell. Welcome back. It's
got to
be late for you, too.
We would never expect you to, but very much appreciated. Thank you so much.
It's got to be late for you, too. Thank you so much, my friend. Mika Il. Nice.
Mika Il.
Can we just call you Mike? Love this Chaplin and the Neo. Yeah, Tim. I'm a fan of this model, man.
2 a.m.
Holy hell. hanging in tight on the late night from South
Mike's
Africa.
Good. All right, Mike
Mike's good. Is. All right, good. Mike is our Mike's your name now. Thank you, Mike. All right, gang. Well, that right there just blew the top off and got us to two giveaways. We don't ever do a giveaway in the first hour of the stream, so come up at the top of the clock at 6 o'clock. We will do one. We like to give everybody a chance to get in here and get settled before we start doing the shenanigans. So hold tight, and thank you so much for allowing us to do that. You guys rule. I can't forget that I got to do a little bit of transition on this too. Not just on the armor. Remember, you're painting everything in this method. So you've got to start giving the same shadow and attention to detail to all of the pieces, including this tabard. Do a little bit of dark gray on the insets here. Got this neat... What would you call this?
Diagonal. 30 minutes.
30 minutes before we do giveaways. Dolls, I feel like that's pretty good. We got everywhere else pretty good. So now let's move on to our medium gray. Again, very, very wet. Pretty much a glaze
Thank
consistency.
You, Mike.
Not quite dirty water, right? But just a little bit more pigment than that, but not too much. And now you want to start working in between the areas that you've created here. So let's see if I can do a better job of staying on camera. I feel like I want to be right here, so let's make the camera submit to our will here real quick. All right. So the key now is to join these areas where you've got the brighter white from the can, right, and the darker gray. So I'm going to just kind of glaze in between those areas. Right. Like so. Make sense? I had white on the top of the knee. I had the dark gray on the bottom of the knee. And now I'm just coming in with this light gray glaze right in between
Nicholas,
the two.
Welcome. Thank you for the follow.
Nicholas! Welcome, my friend.
Right. Do you plan on selling airbrushes in the store?
It's a thing we're talking about. You know, we've used the excuse all along that selling the airbrush is one thing, selling the compressors is a totally different deal. So we're not quite settled on how that's all going to pan out, right?
So Desire, if you are wanting one soon, they're like, you need to wait.
Yeah, same thing here. We've got our spread of white gives us this kind of triangular effect on the greave. We painted the dark gray over from the left, so we're just going to split the difference here. Kind of put this medium gray right in between them.
Vallejo went up on the website today. Well, Model Air went up on the website.
Yeah, Model Air made it on the website today. There are no pictures for the colors yet. We'll be doing that through the weekend, unfortunately. But yeah, the paints themselves are up there. So if you know the color by name that you're looking for in the Model Air line, it's very easy to find it right now. Just like all the other paint sections on our site, you just go into the Vallejo Model Air section, pick the color you want, run with it. Right? Again, just split the difference. We have the dark gray that came over from the black, and then we go very, very light in the light gray, and then eventually we'll have our little white line over here. I covered it up a little bit on this side because it wasn't very bright in the first place. I can take an opportunity here to kind of do these edges a little bit.
Mike, we have it all. We just haven't put it on the store yet.
What's
that? Do we have all the game color?
All the game color.
Every color.
Well, there are six of the colors that got back ordered on us, and I can't. Scarlet red, I think, is one of them. So there's a couple of colors that didn't make it here, but we do have the full line. We will carry the full line, so. There will just be a couple of colors that are out of stock until they back order us on them. Ship the back order stuff.
So, do you want to work on that this weekend, getting those up on the...
Yeah, all of that will be done over the weekend. All the Vallejo paints will be done this weekend. Guaranteed. With color chips and the whole nine, so that you'll be able to see the color that the name, you know, is going up against. Right? Same thing here on the thigh. Dark gray in the inside of the thigh, this little bit of overspray from the white here, and we're just going to split the difference. Very, very wet is the key. Right? Very, 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 very wet light gray paint so that it does not build up texture. It blends in very nice. See how that blends? Can't really tell. There's a lot of brush stroke there. Right.
Stiney is asking more about your mix for the white.
Mm-hmm.
So it's 50-50.
I know a website that shows monkeys doing it.
Airbrush medium, 2 paint, then 50 water.
Depending on the, okay, if you're using the airbrush medium, no. It's 50-50 airbrush medium to paint, and then that solution, 75-25 to water. The airbrush medium is already thinner than a standard acrylic medium. If you use like a Liquitex or a Vallejo medium or, you know, whatever, Lamian medium or whatever the hell they've got out there, I don't know, any kind of acrylic medium that's thicker, then you can go 50-50 and then 50-50 with water. But for the airbrush medium that I use, it's 50-50 airbrush medium to paint, and then that solution, 75% of that solution, 25% water, because it's already very thin. Okay, again, dark gray. Blend out here on the top of this tabard with a little bit of the light gray out to the edge.
You want a t-shirt with his face on it?
My face? That's a little weird.
Limited edition shirt should be a reward for the wheel.
Shirts are always hard, right? Kenny's doing shirts, and God bless him, but knowing the sizes everybody wants is a pain in the ass. He does the pre-order stuff so that everybody gets to order.
Yeah, we do have the option for you to order shirts here.
Yeah, you can click down below and get one of the Bomb Snail shirts for sure. It's all done through Teespring, I think, is who we're using now. And then you don't have to worry. Like, we don't ship them. We don't size them. You get to pick whatever color you want, and then, you know, you basically, they ship it and fulfill it, and then we just make a portion of the proceeds go to us. They make the lion's share of the profits, but we're okay with that because we don't do anything about it, right? I mean, we don't have to worry about what sizes we stock. T-shirts are a pain in the ass, man. They're kind of a good loss leader. But to actually do and do right, you got to carry and stock all the sizes and everything, and that's a pain in the butt sometimes.
That should be our next emote. Ray Silver wants a unicorn with sunglasses that says Thug Life in English script.
Oh, hell yeah. I can see it. I can see it happening.
With, like, a bandana.
A little bit of light gray on the outstep here. We didn't get a whole lot of white down on the foot here, but I know where I want it, so I'm going to go ahead and just kind of use the gray as the highlight on the toe there. Pull a little bit out. And then as we go lighter, I'll just blend the light in with that. Here we'll go with a little bit of the gray on the side of the skull leading into the white.
Bob's your uncle said, "Hail, weird guy that paints stuff."
What's going on, Bob's? Good to see you, my friend. How the hell you been? Been playing any ranked tanks, man? Is that a thing?
Mike wants to know if model air is good for standard brush technique.
Yes, it's all we use on here mainly. I mean, there's a couple of colors I use for model color, but that's the reason why I'm not carrying model color in the store. I feel like model air is so great off of the brush for the kind of painting that I do that I wouldn't really ever say you needed anything else.
Bob gave up on World of Tanks.
Okay. Good man. Should have long ago. Some reason.
Angry.
Still. She walks in here and she's like, "Why do you play this game?"
Oh, I don't understand.
I'm like, "You'll never understand. You just don't understand. You just don't get it." What the difference between all these areas where the dark gray and the white from the rattle can is showing you where to do it. Blend as you go.
I think we have Vallejo Era Metallics. I feel like I unpacked.
Yep, there are some metallics in the standard line. It's not the true metallic air stuff that they've released recently. But yes, we do have all of the normal metallic colors for the model air line. We have all, literally, all 217 model air colors are in stock right now.
And
guaranteed.
There were three that looked identical. I think it was like aluminum, silver, and chrome.
Yeah.
They all looked exactly the same.
They're not when they come out of the bottle, but yeah, they look very, very similar.
They look the same.
Again, just keep splitting the difference right through the middle of where you put that dark gray and up into the lighter color from the rattle can. So just a hair into the dark gray, a hair up into the white.
Oh, Gray Silver said, "No, I mean, how do you feel about them opposed to the game color metallics?"
The Vallejo Model Air Metallics?
Yeah.
The Model Air metallics are okay. They're too thin to begin with, because the whole gist with Model Air is that they're built for airbrushes. So if you want to do a lot of like glazing like we did yesterday or the day before on the Rat King guy that we're doing, you know, if you want to get that kind of an effect, use the game color stuff. If what you're looking to do is paint more full-bodied with your metallics, then the Vallejo Model Air metallics are fantastic. So they all have their place. Right. And the Model Air color is not the same as metal color. They are labeled the same, but they come out differently. The metal color stuff is fantastic. It's some of the best metallics on the market, I feel. It's a little bit of a pain to get used to, and it doesn't work super well for miniature because it's
right a little.
You know, it's really formulated for working with scale models and stuff. It doesn't spray as fine as you would like it. So that's the only qualms that I have with the Vallejo metals line. Still great paint, though. You can see that starting to take shape. Dark gray towards the back. Our light gray is now starting to filter in up towards the front of the forehead here. Actually, this is more of a mid-tone gray, but you can see how it's starting to make that blend a lot smoother. The speckle you can still see from the can, but it's starting to reduce, right? It's starting to restrict itself into the smaller areas as we push it around the model. Right? But you can still get a good feel for the values that we're setting up. Again, I've said it a bunch of times, if you can have the patience to learn how to paint a model black and white, like legit as if it were in an old-timey movie, you win. Because then it's just freaking put a little bit of color over it. You've already got all your value stuff. That's 90% of the way there.
Max27 has a question about your flesh color chart.
Mm-hmm.
What are the two color spots on the right of every gradient row for?
Those are the what we'll call the shaders that you use for like flush colors. Flush, not flesh. Hang on, let me grab the chart. So he's talking about this flesh tone chart that we did a long time ago. So like in the case of pale, over here where you start doing mahogany plus either dwarf flesh or mahogany plus basic skin tone, all from the Vallejo Model Air line, it gives you that kind of flush color for areas like the eye sockets, you know, like sometimes, you know, the towards the cheeks if you've got rosy cheeks, but literally like this area of the face where blood rushes to, like if you've got a squint, you know, screaming miniature, then there's a lot of blood right here. You know, areas around the muscles where you want to add in that kind of subdermal blood vessel color. That's what these are for. And then, they change based on what you're doing. But even on, like, dark flesh, you add in a little... Mostly you're adding mahogany, right? On the sickly skin, we add green to it, right? We do the gunship green and dark flesh so that it gives it kind of a, you know, a real gross, nasty, nurgly color. But on the rest of them, it's generally mahogany. It's a good base for red. It mixes very well, and it gives you kind of that cool subdermal feel to the blood as opposed to, like, going over the top of it with a red or a purple until you're really comfortable doing that with glazes. This is just showing how you can mix to get those colors and then just blend those into things like I said, like eye sockets, laugh lines, the area around the ear, the neck, you know, where you get a little bit more blood tone in the skin, and anywhere where you've got like your arm bent, palms of the hands, things like that.
Hey, somebody likes us.
Dark Con,
what's going on?
Ray Silver said, is Army painting your favorite workhorse metallic line at the moment, or are there colors you prefer from other companies in the metals to flesh out a spectrum?
No, the game color metallics are fantastic. The Model Air metallics are probably some of my least favorite, unless I'm airbrushing, at which point in time they become some of my most favorite. The rest of them for brush paints, I think the Army color, or the Army painter and the game color are my two favorite right now.
Hang over there?
Yeah.
Okay.
How big of a pressure difference in your brush stroke is this now on the helmet versus when we were doing the greaves? Trainwrecks, good question. I always tend to forget to talk about things like that. Because I'm working so thin, my pressure is generally the same throughout the entire area of the model. Again, notice how thin the paint is that I'm dealing with, right? Notice that as I take paint off the brush, you can barely see any pigment. So typically, it's fairly consistent, and it's going to be fairly light everywhere so that I don't get much of a brush stroke actually, you know, leaving an imprint on the model, so to speak. You know, so as I come in, it's literally just enough to get paint on the surface. I'm never bearing down no matter what I'm doing when I paint. Like, it's very rare that you'll see me with a heavy hand on anything that I do. I paint with the tip of my brush most often. I don't have to use a lot of flex. So hopefully that kind of gives you some semblance of what I'm doing. Here, I'll show you. It'll be better to see on the back of the green. Because we've got a lot of black here that the white didn't fall on. But I know that this would be highlighted. So I'm just basically going to come here and I'm using a very light stroke. Notice how, if you can tell, notice how the brush doesn't even flex. I'm literally just barely dragging my brush across the surface. And I'm working my strokes back and forth against each other just to push the pigment and fan it out where I need it and blend those edges. So, I'm just building up a little bit of color on there. Right? I don't want it to be a big chunky line of light gray. I want it to blend. I want it to show some of the black from underneath it. And then if I want it to be a little bit brighter, actually this would be brighter down towards the bottom. So I'm gonna change my brush stroke direction here, make sure I don't have much paint on. And I'm gonna start building up layers coming down towards the bottom side. And along this bottom edge a little bit.
Exactly, Pixel Cats. We can't say strokes on the screen.
Same thing here. I think I want to go to the right side. So I'm just going to basically very lightly start moving paint in on the right side of the heel of the boot. Fuzz that line between that and the black a little bit. So. The key is just thin, you know? Notice how there's very little paint. I can't stress it enough. You go with too much paint, you're gonna know it right away because you're gonna be trying to do what I'm doing here and it's gonna look like, you know, well, I just painted racing stripes all over the guy, these gray racing stripes, as opposed to blending it in with all the paint that was underneath it. And remember, we're going over this with other color. Now, in this case, most of this is going to be black, so we're setting up for a, you know, a pretty good.
Why don't you donate $5 to the cause, and maybe it'll make
Thanks,
you
Ray.
Feel better.
Feeling a black all the way around the model right now. Ray Silver with the 255. Thank you, Ray. Again, let's do the right side of the heel.
Doug Granozel wants to know if you've ever used the Vallejo Extra Opaques. I love the heavy golden brown, gold brown.
Nah. That doesn't, like, in my head, that doesn't benefit anything I do to go with heavy body paints.
DVD.
So it's not anything I've ever really wanted to try. If it works for you, fantastic. I know they got a bunch of really good colors.
$2.55 donation received.
I literally only pick paints based on the color content that they've got, you know, nowadays. It's like if it's something that I feel like I can get mileage out of because it's a color I don't have in any other line, then yeah, I go for it.
Don't take no style.
The hell? Like, is she talking over me again? Or am I talking over her?
You're talking over her.
Yeah, I'm talking over her.
Talk to me about that one big break. I can't hear it.
I can't either. For some reason, she's gotten really, really quiet. I think one of the deep bot updates recently has just made it nearly impossible for
what
us to
What was that, Ray? We only get the first couple of words. DBD said, yo, did I tell you guys I melted $100 worth of Space Marines on accident?
Say, huh? Like by leaving them in your car? How does that happen?
He said, so I went lazy mode and sprayed some Space Marines I had got from a friend to paint up Blood Angel style. I hit it with some red primer, but turns out the primer was lacquer. The lacquer looked like garbage, so I spent a while trying to remove the paint. The only way to remove lacquer is with lacquer thinner, and it melts the miniatures. Oh no.
Yeah, it's a funny thing about lacquer thinner and lacquer. It's basically plastic removal. Yeah, that sucks, man. Yeah, don't ever use lacquer thinner on plastic miniatures.
Oh, it was Lyrics to the Stroke. Okay. That's awesome. Friends, is it a holiday on Monday? Or just a bonus day off? I have July 3rd and July 4th off, Monday and Tuesday. That's an awesome week.
Folds of this tabard as it's underneath. Again, it didn't get much highlight on it, but I know I want a little bit more than what the spray can did, so I'm just gonna come in with this mid-tone gray. Again, just kind of blend it in with the black primer. So. Boring, Mike, repetitive work.
Mike is getting engaged next weekend.
Who is?
Mike!
Uncle Touchy?
Mike, no. That's Uncle Touchy. Mike Yeel.
Oh, what?
Getting engaged next weekend.
Holy That's hell, exciting. Congratulations.
He said pray for me.
Pray for you. Okay, we'll do that too. You let us know how all that turns out. But I feel like that's a good thing, my friend. Congrats.
Wait, what? Oh, are you doing tutorial on July 10th?
Yeah.
Okay, with Ray?
Yeah.
And he's going to be spending part of that day staring at you in a private show.
Yes, he is.
I already got the pole set up. Lucky man, Ray.
I already got the pole set up and everything. All right, so again, we start getting, notice we got our black, our dark gray, our light gray starts coming into that, or our medium gray. This is technically a medium gray, but because it's lighter than everything else we're doing on the model right now, it starts to look like, you know, the lightest color. Again, so right around the cusp of this shoulder pad, I'm gonna start bringing some in.
He said, never mind me, the pole dance. Was that included or was that extra?
We'll talk about that at the time, my friend. Just come prepared.
You get a menu at the beginning. You get to pick what you want.
Yeah.
And then the price is negotiated.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. She knows the drill. Like she's done this before. Hey. Wait, what? Say what?
Who? DVD said, my boss is a piece of shit and won't let me have the day off. I would quit if I wasn't self-employed.
Yeah, exactly. Same with me. Same with me. It's a hard life, man. The struggle is real.
It sure can re-race.
Re-racing.
Re-racing. It's been a hard time with names.
That one threw you off? That's an easy one.
I feel like DVD's married. I think he's just okay. Yeah. Oh, that's nice. That's a good way to say it. That being married is great. Getting married is terrible. Probably.
Yeah. Yeah.
Still, one more name reminded Ray that there's no sex in the champagne room.
Uh-oh.
And LT reminded Still One More Name that there's also no champagne in the sex room, because you wouldn't want to break the glasses with all the roughhousing.
Hey, whoa! I feel like that's probably true. I feel like all of the above are probably true. again, blur these dark gray lines in with our lighter grays. Beat as necessary until you feel like you
did. Did you get your pillow, Ray?
Pretty decent setup there. I like that. Now we're going to start making a bigger impact because we're going to start going in with white over the top of this. And the reason I skipped to the white...
That's awesome.
...is because when you glaze with the white going over the medium gray, you're going to get a brighter gray, so you have a little bit more flexibility. If we'd have just started with white, going back over just the little bit of white that we had from the aerosol can, and then into black, you're not going to get a steady transition as much. You're going to go from light gray to dark gray real quick, and you're going to get a really weird kind of midline because that aerosol can doesn't give you a smooth transition like an airbrush does. So that's why we take the time to do the grays. For the whites now, we don't have to go to super light gray and then to white. We can just go white now and back over because that mid-tone gray that we've put on here is bright enough that when we start hitting this model with white, it's really going to start poking out. So again, we're using our titanium white, this custom mix that we've been doing over the last couple of days. Trust me, go get titanium white, make your life a lot easier, and mix some up. But again, super, super thin. Lots of water. Again, I'll show you on my skin. Notice how there's very little pigment, right? Every paint that I've been painting with has been this thickness. And we can just kind of start testing it on an area where you're not near as concerned. Down here on this tabard piece.
I'll just throw back my legs and pollute my britches with delight.
Samurai named Marcus.
Samurai! Thank you so much. Some hype in the chat. All the support today is awesome.
It's almost 6.
All week. Yeah, we got some giveaways to do.
We do. Mike said, I just set up a one-on-one tutorial next Saturday. What happens if by some unfortunate horribleness I end up having to reschedule?
All you gotta do is let us know. You'll probably want to let us know through email if you have an issue, instead of waiting for the system to do it, because the system won't let you cancel, or will it? Maybe the system will let you cancel at any point, but if you need to just change, better to just send me an email and say, hey, I need to change. That's what we just had a customer that did that. Ray just did that the other day. He needed to change. All right, so notice how now with the white, we start getting a much bigger increase in value. But because we're going super, super thin again, right? That gray is poking through and we're getting really good transitions that you're gonna have to spend a whole lot of time to get with your brush normally. We're gonna get them a lot quicker because we're going thin and we took the time to put that light gray on there, right? Same thing here, just very thin, almost like a line highlight and just feathering it a little bit into that gray. As it dries, it will thin out. You can amp it where you need to.
Steiny said, okay, you are correct. This is the best white ever. The pigment is on point, even thinned further.
Yeah, I mean, seriously, like as thin as you can make it, it still holds together. It doesn't get chunky. You know, you've always heard me say the only reason that you didn't see me paint with it before is that I was too lazy to mix it. It took us getting in the custom mix bottles that we sell on the store now for me to be like, hey, look, I have a whole wall of bottles now. Let's do that. Get a little bit of white back up in here. Again, because I'm so thin, that little line that I pull up in there tends to be more of a gray. So I can amp up even some of the details on the inside here. If I've got tears on the side of the fabric, I want to keep a little bit of that detailing. And I can just go in very lightly, start amping that up.
LT said he has lots of issues. How big is your email inbox?
I didn't say I'd handle just random issues. Or did I? Damn it.
Maybe you did.
Damn it.
I always, when I do my tutorials, I always say, do you have any questions? Or actually, even with the new people we hired, I'm like, do you have any questions about our products?
Colossal! Great day. Welcome. Thank you for the follow, my friend. Again. Pull the white on the skull up out of that gray. Don't overtake the gray too much. Blend a little bit. Side. underside of the eye sockets, a little bit on this temple.
If you haven't entered the raffle yet, get in on that. We'll be doing a couple of drawings here in a minute. Please make sure you follow the channel as well.
Yeah, you have to be following and you have to be here to win.
You have to be here.
Unless you're one of our gold VIPs, then we know you're following, but you don't have to necessarily be here to win. They're the lucky bastards that get to be included.
Why don't you donate $5 to the cause and maybe it'll make
you
feel
Mike.
Better.
That rounded it out to 3.
Holy hell, Mike. Thank you so much. Brighten it up on this left side, his right side. I'm going to keep working through this white as soon as I get a little bit further. As soon as I get the paint done on the palette, then we'll...
Tiny, we do sell these little bottles, too.
We do what?
We sell the little bottles.
Yep. The bottles are on the store, the custom mix bottles.
With the
glass bowls.
Glass bowls. They got some glass balls in them.
Brighten up the outstep of that foot.
Aw, LT.
Top of this knee pad over here. I'm just kind of bouncing around as I see values that I want to amp up and, you know, then work from there. There's no real rhyme or reason to why I'm painting one area of the model first and then moving.
We can get 3 giveaways. Why not?
Why not?
Squad deserves 3 giveaways.
I like your thinking, my friend. So again, and I amping up out of that mid-tone gray.
Oh, so not for his paint that he, his white that he mixed. Okay, got it.
What's that?
Well, I don't know. I missed part of the thing, but he was saying that he could get a get little ketchup bottles.
Oh, cool.
And I thought it was talking about for mixing up the paint mixture that you have.
Oh, gotcha.
That he was doing. But it's something else. Dropper bottle to control the water.
Oh, yeah. That
oh,
we don't
your
have
other, that's that other thing you use, though.
Yeah, that okay. We don't have yet.
We don't have that.
Over here, I'm just going to kind of stipple in and blend in a little white that'll be a kind of a triangle widening out towards the bottom of the greave here. And pushing it so thin that I get pretty good blend in between that gray. So, start to see that kind of metallic sheen that we can build up. We've gone from dark gray on the inside of the grave, the medium gray, and now the white. And the white, as it blends, gives us not only a light gray right here in the middle, right, but then it starts getting brighter towards the outside as I need it. And I'll continue to build the white up and strengthen it, but I want to let this first layer just kind of block in the value where I need it, and then I'll come back. Don't try to, when you're working thin like this, never try to do too much in one area at the same time. Keep moving on the model, right? So I'll come in and I'll grab a little bit on the tips of these toes, whatever the hell this is on the feet.
Slow books are just points that are based on donations and subs, but
they're just a way for us to track what's going on.
They establish the VIP status. They don't have any other use than that. So you can type in !! slow bucks or !! VIP.
Now I'll go back after this area is dried up a little bit and put a little bit more of a bright white sheen where I need it to get that metallic feel. Right. Notice how I'm just going in, and again, I'm splitting the difference between the light gray and what was left over from our spray can, but I'm covering up all of what the spray can did now. I just wanted that as a marker, whereas on the airbrush, when we do this, we might actually leave a lot of this because it's a lot smoother. But when we went in with the rattle can primer, right, notice how we get all that speckling. So we've got to cover all that speckling up. And so that's what we're doing now with the white, like down on the greave and the knee, is we'll just cover
the
it all up.
Gallery.
And my white on this. I've got dark gray on the inside of the thigh, the middle gray coming out here, and I want a line of light. Now, this is a cylinder, and the way we highlight a cylinder is a lot different. You don't just keep going with the white around the edge. It basically just forms a line on the body of the cylinder. And then right behind that line of white, depending on how shiny you want it, either goes back to a mid-tone gray, and then again to dark gray, and then to black, or it goes straight to black if you want it super chrome looking. Right, so right now we're just gonna kinda keep feathering in just a very, very narrow line of white right down the thigh.
Hey, somebody likes us.
Huh. As in something that holds back water? Isn't that
Mike Dyke? What's going on? Alright, I'm gonna get a little bit of water on this brush. Kinda smooth this edge, push and pull into that paint edge that I just did.
G. Finnegan said maybe it was just the primer I was using at the time, but does dusting the model like that with a rattle can leave a texture on the surface?
It does, yeah, and that's why you don't do it very hard. You know, if you were here at the beginning, what I was talking about is make sure that you do not take more than one slight dusting at about 5 inches away from the model. No further away than that. The further away the can is, the more speckling you get, all right? So you've got to be very careful. You only do it once on the front, once on the back, and then call it a day. And then you do what we're doing here with the brushwork to amp up those values and get them where you need them to be. You're basically just using it as a cheat sheet, right? We talk about that a lot, like a way to have a kind of a paint by numbers in front of you that you know is going to tell you where the highlights and shadows need to fall and guide your hand for your brushwork. There I've gone in and I've actually covered up on, across this entire leg, I've covered up all of that kind of spotting. Right? Now the glaze is a little wet. You're gonna get some shine and oversaturation there, but it goes from dark gray to mid-tone gray and then that brief line of white to give you that metallic along the cylinder that should fall in line as close as you can to the other shapes of bright white that you do, right? Like down here. You kind of want them to be in line as much as possible. Now this shape on the knee is a lot different, although I guess we could kind of come here and brighten out this side to match a little bit. No harm, no foul in that.
Ray Silver said, I've always had an issue painting black on odd-shaped 3D models. Any tips on keeping your shadows consistent from multiple angles? I find every time I turn the model, I want to highlight somewhere else, and I go cross-eyed. Only happens when painting black that way.
You gotta just stop, right? I mean, it's like I just said, like if you're doing something like a Space Marine where you've got this cylinder shape that keeps coming around, then you just gotta stop. And you gotta know that, okay, I do a shine on this side, and then, yeah, I'll have like a reflection on the back here, but I don't wanna do too much to overpower that. You just gotta let it be black. You gotta figure out the focus for your model. And in most cases, it's the front, right? I mean, in most of what we do in miniature, we're trying to draw attention to the front of the model, not the back. You still want the back to look good. Right, but you don't have to necessarily do the same amount of work back there. And so you can just leave most of your shine and your real work up front and then blend towards the back into darkness again.
Yeah, Ray, that's why he doesn't usually wear them.
What's that?
The pants especially drive me insane.
Yeah, pants. Pants are horrible. I vote no for pants. No pants. Again, so now we're going to come up on the top of this chest area and lightly, very lightly with the wet paint, start building up in and around these rivets that he's got on here. Just use these loose brush strokes with very, very thin paint. There's not much even left on the brush right now, which is good, right? Because then it blends really, really nice and easy to that light gray. cheekbones really pop out. Airing up until that gets bright like you want it.
No pants, no problems.
The underside of this lip.
That's awesome, Steiny. Steiny said my father did not enjoy pants either. You knew which of my friends he liked. He wouldn't bother putting pants on.
Ah, that's funny as hell.
Certain friends come over, it's like, ah, it's just that kid. Sit here in my underwear.
That's funny. I feel like that reminds me of stories about my stepdad as well. Now that we're on this conversation, I feel like maybe that was part of my life as well, that I've tuned out. I want the forehead to be the brightest part, so I'm going to take my brush strokes from where my gray is up into the peak of the forehead here. The thin paint will drag towards where you stop the brush stroke. So it'll give you a natural blend from the back and then give you more opacity up here on the front where we want it. You just kind of stipple to fill in the gaps. Now we've got a nice shine that goes from our dark to our mid to our lights. Just treat every section of the model a little bit differently, right? This ear is going to have a little bit of a brighter shine on the top. Same with the little secondary tier on it. And just brighten those up. This cheek over here is kind of hidden by the shoulder pad, so I don't want to go as bright over here, except on the extremity of the protrusion of the cheek. Same with all these devices down in here. Not quite as much of the white. Let it remain more gray back inside of that. This is a lesson in looking at your values and amping them up as you do. Like, as I get this forehead bright, like I've got it, I might say, okay, I really like that, but now it makes the ear too dull, or it makes this area of the collar right here too dull. So I go back and put a little bit more white right there, right? So that I keep a good value in this area. I'm not looking past the general vicinity of where I'm painting right now. So I'm only looking at the head and the top of the chest and the neck. I'm not worried about the knee, because if I keep looking here and I go, oh, that white looks really good, bright, I should brighten up this knee. That's not how it works, right? Everything down below should actually be darker, right? You would be lighter up top, darker down below. So just be careful and don't fall into that, oh, wow, you know, I really like the blend I did on the helmet here and that bright white looks really good. I should amp all these up to match that because it'll look that good. Yeah, it'll look that good, but it won't be natural, right? You want your brightness to stay on the head, shoulders, and from the, make a V from the belly button or the crotch up to the shoulders, make that V pattern. And everything inside that V should be the location of your brightest highlights. Arms become secondary because it all depends on the pose. If like this guy, he's got a hand up high, well then I'll have brightness up in here because it reaches up into the height level of the top of my V. Right, so as that V spreads from the crotch to the shoulders, it gets wider. Anything up in this width area up top should be brighter. Okay, as it goes down and narrows, it should get less and less and less until you're finally down at the legs, where normally I only get like the top of the knees, maybe a little brightness on the thigh and the toes that poke out, heels on the back depending on the pose, but not everything. So like not all, I won't go amp up a lot more white in this this scroll work down here, maybe a little bit. But I won't continue to work on it like I do up here. So I'm just paying attention to head and chest area right now. But the head is brighter, right? So I brighten up that collar. Now the collar's bright and it makes the chest too dark. So I keep chasing that white, right? I don't add too much, but I wanna get in here and start brightening up right here at the top of the chest as well. Match that same value that I've got set up on the forehead and now on the cheeks. And working thin gives you the opportunity to continue to keep coming back and retouching to get it set exactly the way you want to. As opposed to you go in real opaque, you get it too bright in one area, and then you're kind of stuck, right? But I could come back in real quick and just brighten up the ring right around the top of the chest, still, and now it makes the middle of the chest not look near as bright because I brightened it up even further right around here. And see how now this value that we've got set on the head and the pecs kind of part of the front of the chest there, starts really telling a much better story. We're almost ready for a giveaway because my white's about dried up. I just want to work through as much of this as I can. I've got the brightest part of the forehead right here, so I'm going to make that line in the mohawk thing right there to be the brightest spot as well. And then start fading back from there. Keeping that edge brighter. Shine line right across the front.
Bits are another way of donating.
Yeah, bits you buy from Twitch directly, and they charge you more. So if you're gonna buy like, I think for $10 you get 700 bits or something like that, you know? So they make their money by charging you at the sale of the bits. And then when you give bits to a streamer, they get all of the proceeds from that. As opposed to, you know, if you sub, Twitch takes a portion of that and we don't see all of it. That's really the only difference. All right, let's do some giveaways. My white on the palette is dry. We'll get back to it in just a second. But hopefully you can tell where we're going and how now, right? Now we're starting to look even better than just an airbrush pre-highlight, right? Right. The airbrush pre-highlight, while it gives you a smoother transition, we didn't spend the time to do the grays on it. We just did it with white. And so when you're just looking at that airbrush transition, it looks really good. But then if you do this work with a brush, right, now look at how much different the brush work looks and how our values are set as we go through the dark gray, the mid-tone gray, and the whites. You have to do that with a brush in order to get the blends, because the brush doesn't have some miraculous way of blending the colors from white to black and getting all those grays very easily. You can do it if you glaze white super, super thin and then more and more and more and more and more, but it would have taken 10 times the amount of time that we're doing right now. Right, but you can see how we get a really, really good stone look, almost like we're painting, you know, a statue over here. And we get smooth transitions, we get a good look on it, and you're doing it all with a brush. You didn't even have to own airbrush. We haven't done anything with the airbrush, except I did prime him with the airbrush. I'm not gonna lie, I primed the black, but cheater, cheater.
Ray, bits cost you more. And they also don't trigger the wheel spin. Unless you change that. But they would get a custom sketch.
Yeah, but I've been super, we still owe people two sketches or three sketches. And I'm like so horrible with sketches, so I'm glad she brought that up. but we stopped doing that. I love doing all the things, but when people take months to get them, it doesn't make me happy. So
bits don't have a giveaway. Associated.
5,000 bits gives you an additional spin on the wheel.
Oh, 5,000.
Just like everything else. Okay. So every 5,000 bits, it's just like 20 subs or $50 in the critical mass. Okay. Pixie Lou, thank you so much for the host.
Pixie.
How the hell are you doing, Pixie?
Thank you.
Rossinante, what's going on?
Why don't you donate $5 to the cause?
Star.
To Gnozzle, that's nasty. That's dirty. James, stay stealth with the $20. Holy
you.
Hell. James, my man from back east. One of the bestest of the best. Thank you, my friend.
$20 donation received from James.
I have only met James once at Adepticon, right? And yet, I feel like you need more James time in your life. I feel like that's a thing that you need.
Because you had the live awkward man stare, didn't you?
Oh, yes. Yes. Yes.
Special bond.
Somebody likes us.
McWeasel.
McWeasel. Thank you for the follow. Welcome from... Just a junk posh. Genuine, what's happening, man?
Genuine.
Saturday, Schmatterday. It's still Friday night, party time. Woo! Michael's like, no, round numbers, damn it.
First stream of Pixie Lou.
What? The first stream? Holy
Congratulations.
Hell.
Congratulations.
Now, didn't I? Oh, but I think she was talking to you guys on Discord the other night, right? Was that what I was hearing? Not actually a stream? Pixie, that's awesome. How'd it go?
Yes, we did see it. Thank you, Pixie.
Always more James time. I know, man. You give it freely. We've heard that about you. You're a little easy. You're a little easy. We don't like talking about it on a stream, but let's reel it in there. All right. Giveaways. Let's do some giveaways.
That's awesome, Pixie. it's his beard. It's impossible to resist.
My beard? Or his beard?
Maybe James.
Okay,
James
maybe his, beard. Not mine. My gray bastardized beard is
I like your beard.
I'm glad somebody has to. Somebody, I don't mind it. But I have to live with it, so I have to like it. Captain Chaos coming in with a host. Thank you, Captain Chaos. All the love on a Friday night. All right, so for those of you that are new around here, make sure that you type exclamation point booty to get involved in the raffles. If you have not done so already, it doesn't cost you anything. It's free to everybody. Our VIP system is built around donations and subs here. So as you sub, you build up VIP points. As you donate, you build up more VIP points. I'm going to go check those right now to make sure everybody's sitting at the right level. As we say that, make sure everybody's where they need to be. Sniper Bob made it up to silver. Congrats, Sniper Bob. So as you climb the VIP ladder, you get different bonuses. Those bonuses allow you for extra chances to win in all of our wheel spins. So if you're bronze, you get double the chances over a normal viewer to win in every one of these giveaways. If you're silver, you get 3 times the chances. If you're gold, you get 4 times the chances. And if you reach gold VIP during the course of any month, you also get the chance to win even if you're offline. So our gold VIPs don't have to be here to win a wheel spin. Everybody else does. And your VIP status lasts for 30 days, or it lasts a month from whenever you get it. So if you hit, just now Sniper Bob hit VIP silver, he'll hold silver until July, whatever, 15th, 16th, whatever this is. So he'll hold it until July. So it doesn't end, your VIP doesn't end at the end of every month. It goes for 30 days from when you get it. So it gives you the incentive during the month. If you sub and you get bronze at the end of the month, you can go that little extra distance, get silver, and you'll hold silver for another 30 days. So just as an update, let's do some giveaways now. Everybody's where they should be. You got the drum roll?
I do.
Let's see. How many are we doing? 3? Holy hell, you guys are crazy. Yeah. 3 giveaways. So we're drawing 3 people. Make sure you get your name in the raffle. Exclamation point. Booty.
Ready?
Drum roll. G. Finnegan. Congrats. Our first winner of the night. Oh, boy. The winks I have in store for you, G. Finnegan. G. Finnegan, are you here? It says you're here. I'm assuming you're here. I'm going to drink some of my delicious Moscow Mule while we're waiting. Pump it up in chat.
G. Finnegan.
G. Finnegan.
Give us a hi or a thumbs up.
Gotta give us a, oh my God, wow. Oh my God, wow.
Gotta know you're here.
Speak now or forever, hold your peace.
Can't leave the stream.
We'll give it away.
If you gotta go to the bathroom, take your phone with you.
Yeah, you gotta take us mobile if you go poop. Them's the rules. G. Finnegan, wake up! Stop pooping! Stop pooping! Somewhere in the world, there is a pair of headphones lying on the ground that a cat is looking at funny because the headphones are screaming, stop pooping! Stop pooping!
Come on, G. Finnegan.
G. Finnegan!
Yes, mobile pooping is the way to go.
Mobile pooping. Yes, definitely. There is no reason during the course of a stream to run off and do anything without taking us with you. Haul your whole computer with you. All right, let's give us the next one, and we'll come back to G. Finnegan if he doesn't pop up. We're gonna give it away to somebody else. Dragon! Congrats, Dragon!
Super pooping. That's something that could be different.
What's that?
Well, DVD said super pooping.
Oh, super pooping is a totally different thing around here. I don't know about you guys.
It's around our house.
That's a totally different thing. Dragon is here. He ain't wasting no time. Yay. Thank you, Dragon, for hanging out with us. All right, let's pick the third person.
Evis
341. Holy hell. Evis.
Congratulations.
Give us a thumbs up in chat, Evis. Let us know you're here. Let us know what's going on. Don't make me drink. G. Finnegan, don't make me drink my whole drink. Evis, hell yeah.
Yeah. How about G. Finnegan?
G. Finnegan. Running out of time, my friend.
That's why they made diapers.
G. Finnegan, you won. Type in chat.
Papa said now I can see the half poop shuffle happening of people trying to.
Oh, right? Exactly. As they're like typing and getting all excited. There's lots of poo fingers in store for the world. Is it Finnegan? This one doesn't do the auto type.
F-I-N-N-I-G-A-N? Yeah.
Type in
toilet
chat.
Remote.
You won. G. Finnegan.
Oh, there he is.
Okay. Jesus, right, Pete's man.
Just in time. You won, and we were about to re-roll.
You were legit on the end of the timer, my friend. All right. So, G. Finnegan, you're up first. You're up for, and you know what this means, G. Finnegan. You're the first winner of the night. Even though you weren't here, we're still going to hold it to you. All right. We're still going to make sure that you're the one. So, G. Finnegan, and I apologize ahead of time to anybody that's new on the stream and has not been here for a giveaway before. Actually, I don't apologize at all. We have a thing here called...
Oh, you're just playing the piano.
The awkward man stare. And the awkward man stare exists for one sole purpose. And that purpose happens to be to fill the distance between us, Jen and I, and you, the winners and viewers of the world out there. Flood the internet between us with massive amounts of awkward. So, G. Finnegan, bring it in close and make it as awkward as possible. You might want to remove other family members, dogs, pets, small living creatures from the room. They've been known to have the need for emergency procedure to fill up too close.
Definitely scarred them for life.
But make it happen.
Jason's not wearing pants.
Not that I'll admit. And G. Finnegan, for being the first winner of the night, do you know what you did? Do you know what you did? Oh, the ambidextrous wink.
Ambi-wink.
Oh, yeah. Congrats, G. Finnegan. Let's see what he wins. Let's see what he wins. I'm glad that you have a life, Gnozel, where that's a thing that you can do. I technically do. I didn't have to put pants on today. I don't think I've seen anybody other than Jen. Vanguard Paladors. Congrats, G. Finnegan. A set of two of the Stormcast Eternal Vanguard Paladors. Those will be the Chicken Riders. Congratulations, my friend. Or Griffin Riders. I don't know what the hell they are. Everybody calls them Chicken Riders. So that's what you got. Dos Paladoros. All right. Who's next?
Dragon.
Dragon. Dragon, you're a vet here. You know the drill. Let's do this. Get close,
not a,
Dragon.
Not a blink when you do them separately, Orcus.
All right. I might pull something if I go too long, so let's make this happen. I didn't stretch, so I could wind up with a severe injury out of this, so I'm taking one for the team is what I'm doing. A Custodes squad, holy hell. Congratulations. Dragon winning some Custodes. Amazing. And last but not least.
Oh, wait.
A noob. I don't believe you've won before. So I think that what we'll be doing is breaking the noob winner in the correct way.
Ooh, with the giant awkward man there.
You know who. Hopefully you understand the power of awkwardness. No, really?
I've seen that one before.
I'm full of all sorts of new tricks.
That was pretty special for you.
Tau Pathfinders. Dirty, dirty Tau. Congratulations to all of our winners tonight. Thank you guys so much for all the support that allows us to do this. It means the world. We love to bring the hobby to people. We have got an unending stream of thanks and things coming back from people to get the prizes that we give away, all sorts of new goodies for them to paint with and to paint on. And none of it's possible without you guys. We love being able to take the support you give and turn it right back around to the community to ensure that everybody's hobby game gets stepped up.
Man stare.
Super awesome.
I don't even try to hide it.
All because of you guys. What's that?
Elric said, is it me or is Jen really into your man stare?
Oh, it's just like, it's like game over.
Yeah.
It's game over for her. Somebody type exclamation point winner in the chat.
I just did it.
Did you?
Yes.
All right, fantastic. So if you want a prize, follow that link. Get your butt over there and make sure that you fill in the Google form that we've got set up that will give our address, give your address to us, not give our address to you. That wouldn't do you any good. Give your address to us along with your Twitch name to match it up to. And we do usually about every week to 10 days we mail out prizes. We let a week to 2 weeks tops build up and then we go and make a big run and do it. So expect that within the next. We've got a mailing coming out on Monday. So you guys are lucky tonight, Evis, that and the rest of the gang, that you'll be getting yours quickly. So thank you guys again so much. The raffle is not closed. If we hit more, which we're getting close to another one, we'll be doing more giveaways. So make sure that you type exclamation point booty to make sure your name is still in for the draw. You can only win once a night, so everybody that's already won is out. But everybody that hasn't won is still in, technically. And so, also at the end of the stream, we'll be doing our Treasure Trove Friday giveaway, which is a completely free giveaway that we do every single week. Thanks to all of our channel partners, Vallejo, the Army Painter, Cool Mini or Not, Micro Art Studios, Elric's Hobbies. All these guys pitch in to make sure that we can give really, really cool hobby stuff to people that are new to the hobby. Guys and gals out there like you guys that want to step up your paint game, get a set of new paints. We give away a full set of Army Painter paints. It's the 10 paint starter set along with a couple of brushes, minis from Cool Mini or Not, and bases, custom resin bases, either from Elric's or from Micro Art Studios. So everything other than literally primer and glue and clippers and files and filler. But it's all the stuff you need to get going in the hobby. So for those of you that are out there that have been on the verge of maybe getting into painting miniatures and haven't really wanted to drop the coin or haven't really known where to start, this will be a good chance for you to do that. So every Friday night, 52 weeks out of the year, we do this giveaway absolutely free. So stick around for that. We do that at the end of the stream, and we'll have a lot of fun. And good luck to everybody.
Like in an hour and a half. Hey, so this is an interesting idea here from Mike. We should get another wheel on the store. I'd pay just to get a spin because it's exciting and it gives access to models you usually wouldn't paint. Also, you get exciting chances at randomness, and I love randomness. So, like, on the store, if someone just pays a flat
you could buy
rate,
a wheel spin?
They could buy a wheel spin, and but it would be on the store, not on the stream. You know, or it could be like a grab bag kind of thing. Maybe not a wheel, but, like, we could have a list of these are the things that are up for grabs at this moment, and then we just randomly pick one.
Would we do it to where you buy a wheel spin, like a grab bag thing on the store, but then it happens live?
No, because that would be too confusing, I think.
Well, but we don't have a way to track it. We'd have to build a whole new program because it's not automated to actually write down the winning thing itself. You know? I didn't build it that way.
But no, we just have a slot on the store where they buy...
Eva, send me a message and let me know that. There's not a problem in the world with that. Just send me a message and remind me. Could do it live on Sundays or something, Ray. We'll think about it. Yeah, I like that idea.
Well, live on Sundays could work. A little bit different, but...
We've got some other neat stuff coming away up for giveaways, too, so we'll talk about it. We'll talk about it for sure. Good idea, though. I've been pulling something this whole time. Say what? You see both of my hands for the bulk of the show, I'll have you know. So I'm not the one doing anything rude and crude and socially unaccepted. Drag, do you have a Death Guard color combo in the store yet, Slowfuse? None of the color combos are up until this weekend when all of the Vallejo stuff is up with a SKU so that I can build those groupings. And those groupings will start this weekend, and then I'll continue to work on them all the time. So, you know, like this, just this pre-highlight color coding for like black gray, uniform gray, the light gray. I won't put white in there because you guys all already have a white and a black. But, you know, we'll put that in there as a pre-highlight set of grays.
That's what I was trying to explain.
All that kind of stuff, so.
I think it's a great idea.
What's that?
What we were just talking about. Like a grab bag, not necessarily a wheel spin. That's what they're saying.
We'll talk about it. Random miniatures loot box. Well, we've got a really good idea coming up for some stuff that will go as kind of a super grab bag thing on the stream, but we'll talk about it. Definitely. Orcris, you've already sent it in? Yeah, if it's already in the database, then we got it. Just, I need something that ties those together. You're going to have to send me a message. I'm not going to write it down during the stream. You guys send me a message flow so that I have it in writing that you want me to send those miniatures over to Orc. Random roll items. Yeah, exactly, Elric. All right, cool. So let's get back to doing some highlighting. As you can see, just doing grays, blacks, whites, and getting that pre-highlight set up on the model. Somebody was asking, well, we've had lots of people asking, but yesterday it was specifically asked again as to how we can do it because we started in with our Suriat yesterday, and I went through all the steps of doing pre-highlight and then doing everything with Airbrush. So this, most of the bulk of this model has been done with Airbrush, although the reds I've gone back in and started layering up with a brush. And then some of the other detail, like the non-metallic, like the hip pads and the feet and all that, I've been doing with brush, but very little done with brush. All the rest of it is airbrush. And we get the question a lot on how to come up with the same effect, because this model, all of these bright spots were bright like this, right? They were white undercoat. And then when I spray the brown, it just makes the brown much brighter in those areas and kind of takes care of your first and second sometimes highlights. This brown laid over very, very well on top of the pre-highlight and gave us almost three different tones. So we were able to do very little additional color on this model to get a really cool, rich buildup of kind of a desert tan, desert yellow. And we started it all from, I think, oak brown, right? So it was oak brown, and even though this is a super dark brown, you don't see much of it on the model, it accounts for probably about 60 to 70% of the brown that you're actually looking at on the model, because it looks so much different when it sprays over the white. When the oak brown went over the white, it became this light tan. So it's a great skill to have. It's a great method to use to get your colors to do a lot more work for you with a lot less effort. But if you don't have an airbrush, how do you make it work? And that's what we're doing now. We're showing you that by building up here with the brush and doing the same blends, you can get the same effect. It just takes longer. Brush blending is something that takes a lot of time, especially when it's something like this that can, if you don't go in with the right head mindset, it can get discouraging because you're really doing this pre-highlight as a method, as an undercoat. You're not doing it necessarily as something that you'll see at the end of your paint job. So it's like a second paint job that you have to do, but it is really worth the time and effort once you can kind of develop the patience and the foresight, I guess, on your model, get the right idea of where you want to go, then this stuff is invaluable. Again, very, very thin with my white. Right? Notice how I don't have very much pigment coming off of here at all. Starting on this shoulder. Build up a little bit of a dome pattern here, much brighter at the top, and then bleeding out into my gray as I go down.
You didn't turn your music back on. Man stare.
Oh, that's right. I always forget. The problem is, I won't start at the same spot.
Get down
right?
With the clown!
Wow! I feel good!
So we can just do maybe this one.
TechnoCat said, how do you block the spray if you're spraying another area with a different color so you don't get overspray?
It's good enough for my butt. It should be good enough for my nose.
Does anybody in chat want to tell them what you're supposed to do?
Well, someone said note card.
So I'm the king of do as I say, don't do as I do. Mask your models off. There's a lot of different opportunities to mask. There's masking fluid. Vallejo makes a masking fluid that's okay. I'm not a fan of any of them, actually, because I feel like they offer you too much opportunity to mess your model up. There are a lot of people out there that do wonders with it. But it's a tool that you have to use a lot. The masking fluid is a bluish fluid that you paint on. It turns sort of film rubbery on the model, not super thick, but it does block and mask very well and allows you to mask off peculiar areas, because you basically just go in and paint it on with a brush, a crappy brush, and you could mask a curved area on the helmet or whatever you needed to do and be fine. And then when you're done, you take like a pencil eraser or something and lightly scuff where the film is, and it lifts, and then you can peel it off. It's that process of scuffing it and bringing it up that I hate, because you can really run the risk of marring your model up. So I don't use it. Literally, I paint with no, this was all done with no masking at all, right? So you can watch the VOD from yesterday. I don't use any masking, and we just paint. It's all about angle on the model, as far as like leaving panel lines on margin so you don't get a lot of, you know, bright color up inside of panel lines and things like that. But it's just a matter of control.
Donate $5 to the cause, you're probably going to make you feel better.
With the airbrush that you enjoy the most. Psychotic. Nailing it. There's another giveaway. We're not going to do that one right now. One thing I promised we wouldn't do is we wouldn't upset the stream constantly and not do painting. So we're going to finish this white, and then we'll end it, and then we'll do those giveaways. Thank you, Psychotic. The man, the myth. All right, but yeah, masking is good. I'll use the note card approach somebody mentioned. That one works really well. It is a matter of taking like a thick stock card and like you can tear a piece, let's say, like that.
Music's too loud.
Music's too loud?
Yeah. A lot of people are now saying music probably is louder than
you. Definitely louder than you are.
I think it's louder than you are.
All right. But I can pick out like a piece of card, and I can just tear out a chunk of it, right? And I can make it to where then that fits as a backing for that arm like that. And then this would allow me to spray that shoulder and not get anything on the rest of the Marine. So you can just use cardstock like that. This I feel is a lot better. You can just kind of alter it as you need to. You can take the flat into this and push it where you need to. Push it like to block the head off like that, and you can paint the chest. You can put it up inside the shoulder like that so you don't get anything there, you know, and just use the card, you know. Eventually what you wind up with is you'll wind up with a weird shaped rectangle that is like skinny on one end and with an angle and fat on the other, so that you can use the skinny end to get into tight spots and be able to spray like the underside of that helmet, you know, things like that. So I do a lot of this. It takes a little bit of dexterity because you got to hold it in there with one hand, you know, like basically hold it in. Get your thumb on it so you can still then use your airbrush, right? So that's what I do a lot. But the people in chat will let you know that I very rarely mask anything off. I'm horrible about it. I always forget, and people are like, how do you do that? And I'm like, yeah, don't do that at home. Don't try this at home. You'll hate yourself. I messed up more models than I can count because I was just too stubborn to mask anything off. And this brush is very, very dirty again. I rarely need to, from what you've seen. It's just my paint style. I just, you know, I don't airbrush everything, though. You know, like guys that I see, like Tom Shadle, use a lot of masking on models. And it's a thing where I don't airbrush every little spot on the model like some of these guys do. You know, like toolboxes and holsters and the guns and stuff. I'll just do them by hand, right? Whereas a lot of guys like to have that same kind of... airbrush blend on every part of the model. For me, I like the control of texture to be different, so I'll go in on things that are leather and do it all with a brush, right? I'll go in on the metals and do it a little bit differently than with the airbrush. So when you do things like that, it allows you to not have to use the airbrush. So like I won't go in and, you know, if I was doing this airbrush, I wouldn't take the time to mask off and just airbrush the purity seal. I just do it with a brush. You know, I'm doing that Morat. I'm doing his face and a lot of the other details, the hair and things like that, all with brushwork. So that prevents me from having to go in and mask a lot of those smaller details. Now, there are models that I get asked to do or that I like to do in a particular method where I airbrush a lot more, and that's when I mask. Because it's just stupid not to at some point in time. You're going to mess up some of your work. I don't. Most of the time, I don't mask because I'm just lazy. And that's a bad way to be, right? Because it causes you all sorts of issues. I know this face mask is going to be white for the skull portion of it, so I am going to go ahead and brighten it up. I wasn't thinking about that earlier. that we're actually painting a freaking chaplain here, so I do want some of this to be. Again, just watch as the paint comes off my brush and see how thin all this paint is and how very little there is on the brush when I actually go to do the work. And that's the key to this process. Don't get too antsy. Don't try to put too much paint on the model at once. Learn patience. Miniature painting is 9/10 about the patience, I guess. Right?
A skull crusher.
Skull crusher, what the hell's happening? People airbrush gun holsters? Tom Shadle literally airbrushes 100% of his models, I think. I mean, he does a lot of brush work too, but he sets the bulk of it up with his airbrush, and he's fantastic at it, right? But he masks off a lot and gets those super, super tight details in there, uses a very, very fine airbrush. I think he uses like a Sotar or something like that and likes the very, very small needle size. You know, he does stuff that I don't do. So everybody's got their way of painting that makes sense and really makes them comfortable and that they like to do it. I like the idea of my airbrushing and my brush work to kind of blend together to give me two totally separate looks on a model sometimes. That's just what you see from me most of the time. Feathering in the white down into the gray to go along here. A little bit on the top of these shoulder blades. Don't want a whole lot of light back here because the backpack will be covering up most of this, but I want a little bit of highlight. I work that around until I get some brightness right there on the top. Same thing over here. A little bit. Collar around the back.
Silver said, I swear sometimes it looks like you somehow cover your models in those old just add water watercolor books as thin as you paint.
it's just the way I do it.
Where it was like, it looked like a white piece of paper and you just took a paintbrush with water on it and it made the
color. Isn't that crazy?
Appear.
I remember those. Collar.
Jack wants to know if this is going to be a chaplain for your Imperial Fist Army.
Nah, this will probably just be a giveaway, or maybe one of our lucky subs from the 6 month sub model might get this one. I had no intention of keeping this one that I had sitting around from way back. These were the promo ones that came out when I was working at GW. That's how long I've had them. Working in the studio, we used to get, obviously, models every time there were releases to paint and to put our stamp of approval on and stuff. And this was just a group of those that I had had for a long time that I'd never done anything with. Maybe one of you lucky bastards will own it. Yeah, let's do here. Here we have a very a different form of highlight that has to happen. See how this glove area on his forearm has this very sharp line? So we got to be really, really bright right along this line here. Right? So whereas on these other areas, we've been doing things kind of, you know, blended and not real stark transition between brights and darks. Here we want to do the opposite kind of. We want to blend it into the gray up above, but make a very bright line on the forearm guard here, right along this dark edge, because that's the way, you know, this kind of metallic would work. There's that real bright contrast right on this cliff, so to speak. Get rid of most of my paint.
Rajman HW.
And then
thank you.
Blur that together.
Andrew, I'm not sure. Is the 6 month sub model for everyone on the stream, or does it work differently? I don't know how that one works.
That one's no longer in effect. Okay. We had at the beginning, before we were partnered on Twitch, we had a GameWisp subscription, and people that subbed on GameWisp for 6 continual months at the second tier, because GameWisp allow you to have multiple tiers. Twitch does it now, so we've thought about bringing it back at like the $24.99 a month tier for Twitch. If you do that for X amount of months, you can get a free painted miniature. Right now, I'm too busy to commit to that. But if we get to a point where we open up a little bit, I'd be willing to bring that back. But it used to be you'd sub at the higher tier on GameWisp. We have about 8, 9, 10 people that did that for 6 months in a row, which is awesome. Great support to the stream. And in return, they get a painted miniature. So we're doing a bunch of Space Marines and some various other models. And those are just going out randomly. You don't get to pick what I paint. And I just paint it up. Some of them I do on stream. Some of them will just show up on your doorstep. And all of those guys get a miniature. So. Gore. Just finished eating. Holy hell. Skull Crusher, we're doing great. GW sounds like great guys to work for, my opinion, Michael. I liked working there. It was one of the best jobs that I ever had at the time. I feel like when I was leaving, it was no longer that way. They had a great subculture there, or a great work culture, I guess, because of the pseudo-militaristic GW, you know, mentality that went on. Just was amazing. But the business side of what GW does sometimes falls short and makes being an employee there, I think, you know, a pain in the ass. But that's every company on the planet, I guess, right? At least if you're working at GW, you're doing something that's, you know, hopefully you love it. But yeah, it was literally had, I was the regional business manager for the West Coast business operations at the time where they were changing the U.S. business up and pulling everything back into the Glen Burnie office. And so for me, it wasn't an option to stay there. And that sucked because I really, really loved working for GW, but I didn't have the option to stay. I was not going to move to Glen Burnie. It's like the butthole of the world. So. No offense to anybody that lives in Glen Burnie, but it's a horrible place. I had just moved from New York to California about a year and a half or 2 years earlier, I think.
Hey, Peter.
I guess it was like 2 years earlier. Peter, thank you so much. But yeah, good company. I don't know how they are now. A lot different now. So, you know, I worked there years and years and years and years and years ago. I left in 2007, 2006, 2007, something like that. So, go ahead and get a little bit of edge detail on this wrist guard. Oh. Blending in some white on the elbow pad.
Is any of your work in the 5th edition codexes or white dwarves from around that time?
The white dwarves, yes, lots. Lots. If you look on our website, slowfusegaming.com, one of the big pictures in the rotating banner on the main page is my orc Monster Hunter squad. It came from a White Dwarf episode. I think it was LT on here. LT, wasn't it you that won the Soul Drinkers that I painted? I think it was LT that won those. We gave away one of the squads of Space Marines that I painted for White Dwarf that were Soul Drinkers. The 4th edition, when the Black Templar sprues came out, we were tasked with going through and making up different Space Marine chapters out of the Black Templar sprues, using them for things other than Black Templars. And so I built a whole Soul Drinkers squad, command squad out of them.
LT said, yep, I got them way back in the day.
Yep. The LT owns those now.
Gray Silver said, I have some stuff for you to sign.
Those are the good old days. Dave Taylor, who just, we did that Dark Age giveaway for the Nova Open. Dave Taylor, who did the other models in that Dark Age two-player starter set, worked. He was the one of the leads for the U.S. White Dwarf at the time in the studio. And that's where we became friends and worked together. It was during that whole time.
Hey, Ravenous Oracle.
Ravenous, what's going on? Again, just amping certain areas up as I go along, making sure that this stuff up top towards the shoulders is pretty bright. Not overly so, but enough. It tells the story I'm looking to tell.
Mike, I hope you're not going to be operating any heavy machinery tomorrow, early in the morning, since it's 4 a.m. where you are.
Holy hell. That's right, it was 2 a.m. when we started. Yeah. You're a trooper, man.
Awesome Darkness. Darkness, I've got my Wild West Exodus in the mail today.
I like that stuff, man. It's good stuff, huh? I'm actually excited about that game. It's funny, it was owned by a company here local to us, and then they sold it, right? And now it's overseas with the guys from, I think, Wayland Games, which is a storefront, but they're taking over the responsibilities for it, I do believe. All right, so just pushing a little bit of brightness up in between this area where the chain is.
Hey, Zeb.
Zeb Zorander. What's going on, man? Brighten up that portion right underneath it. Like the way this is looking. A little bit more. Some highlight there on that part. Gotta do something about this crazy blocky thing that's on their back. I never really liked that detail on the model. A lot of it gets covered up by the pack. Right, which I don't know which backpack I'm doing. I don't know if I'm going to do a jump pack on this guy or what. I thought about doing a jump pack on him.
Hey, do you know what White Dwarf, that stuff, whatever you sent to LT?
Nah. There was somebody that had like a link to a archive when we were talking about it originally that was really cool that, you know, was showing us which actual issue it was. I used to have all those issues someplace, but it's been years since I've even seen the box that I remember them being in. I found some really old codexes from that time, but I haven't found any of the stuff with my art from that time. And it was like one of those where, you know, I would swear that that box was always around until you need it. And I remember saying that back when we were asking this question when I was when I put them up and you want them. Or LT want them, I don't know if you're asking them.
Yeah, LT. Well, because Ray Silver said, I can check my FLGS if you want. They have a huge bin of back issues. Do you know the issue number?
It would have been 2005, I want to say. I want to say that back then it was like December of... No, it would have been 05, and yeah, it would have been... God. Trying to think of when exactly it would have been date-wise. I just don't know. That's a thing that no longer sits in my brain pan.
Oh, Sailor Jeff. I saw your in chat earlier you said tornado sirens.
What?
Sailor Jeff said we got trees down and roads flooding. Still have power.
Holy hell, dude.
Crazy out.
Take it easy.
Be careful.
Do not fall victim to the storm, my friend. Having to work around these whatever you call them.
Are you like in weird spots because we can't?
Rivets. And things. It's a pain in the ass to do what we're doing. Try to keep from building up too much of a brush stroke. right? Because you have to try to keep, when you're working this thin, you have to try to keep all of your strokes going in the same direction. And doing that around areas like what we got here is a little bit hard, a little tricky. I just come to expect it.
I do too. There it is.
It was just late.
The delay, someone jumped in the middle. Eggman said, was that before or after the big release of the Dark Angels?
Dark Angels? What are you talking about? It was the Black Templar. I don't know about Dark Angels. Was there a big Dark Angels release around that time? I don't remember that. Maybe. The Soul Drinker Squad was around the Black Templars because the idea was that we used the Black Templar accessory sprue that they came out with for building other chapters. They wanted to see what we could do with conversions back when White Dwarf really paid attention to that stuff. You know, what we could do to make some really cool conversions out of those sprues that they had released. I need to blend this line on the back here a little bit better. We've got a little bit of a hard edge to this this line on the back of the shoulder guard. So I'm just gonna bring in a little bit of thin white and again work towards the white that I've got on there. So I'm basically pulling from down to up from the way you guys are seeing it. And I am using a fairly heavy hand here, heavier than I do with most of my brushwork, just so I can kind of blur that line in a little bit. So I get a much better transition with it. Now we've got a good spotlight highlight on that shoulder. It doesn't have anything other than those rivets really to break it up. So we got to highlight it a little bit differently.
Porno magazine. Porno magazine.
Large box of condoms. A bottle of Old Harper.
Old Harper.
A couple of those panty shields.
I don't understand the fireworks.
And one of those disposable enemas.
This one?
No, make it two.
Now it's a party.
I'm a fatality.
Here we go.
And Harry Potter and all his wizard friends went straight to hell for practicing witchcraft.
Yay!
Why with a siren?
That's J.P. Gray.
Oh my God, that guy, hassling us.
Shoulda known.
Hassling us. How you doing today, J.P.?
That dog's as subtle as a hand grenade in a barrel of oatmeal.
Blend that line. Again, right between the white and the gray. I put the white on, block it in to where I want the highlight, and then I just kind of come back and distress that line between it and the gray with a little bit of thinner white, and that's what gives me that blend. Want to get a little bit up underneath the shoulder guard, but I don't want to go too bright. You just got to start looking, right? When you're playing with shadow, you don't want to go too bright up here because obviously it's sitting underneath all these other parts of the armor. But I want it a little brighter than it is. Stipple a little bit of white in there, building it up as I go. Don't want to overwork it and get it too wet. Get a little bit of highlight. Same here on the elbow guard.
Hey, did you know cats can jump higher than a house?
What?
Because they have really powerful hind legs. And because houses can't jump.
Oh my God. That's one of those that always gets me because I'm like thinking about, no, they can't. See? I immediately go to, no, they can't.
Some of them, it has to be in the delivery.
You nailed it because you fooled me. If your goal was to fool me with it, then you got it.
Oh, I like that one too. What's brown and rhymes with Snoop?
Dre.
Yep. I think we've seen that one, but I love it.
That's the only reason I know it is because you guys have told that one before.
Love it. AP said, how goes the painting, you nerds?
Damn. Now he's mean to everybody. Just me. Tops of these fingers.
Tiny said, now I Google to see if anyone has ever put a hand grenade in a barrel of oatmeal.
Probably.
Tomorrow we set up. Oh.
The only day that doesn't start with Y?
Yeah.
Is that what they're on?
Yeah.
All right. Feeling pretty good about this. We got this other leg to do.
I haven't. If it's not, I'm not constantly reminded I won't.
What's that?
Humanity. Fuck yeah. The stories that Psychotic Jester was talking about.
Oh,
I think they're on
yeah.
website, or maybe it's on Reddit. What's green and has wheels? Grass. I lied about the wheels.
Oh. That one's a good one, though. I like those. I'll give you an A for that one. It's that top edge. Really brighten up the top edge of this scroll on his chest so that it stands in contrast, because you've got what's called a modulated fade or a modulated highlight here, right? You want the top of the chest area to be bright, right? We've got the collar, the top of the chest, then it goes to a dim color right before it goes to this this scroll or whatever we want to call this. It's on his chest here, and we want to amp that up pretty bright on the edge so that it really stands off of that dull spot that we transitioned down into. Then, from that, we start fading down. Again, and that's why it's called a modulated highlight. It goes bright, dim, bright, dim, bright, dim, right?
Because they're extinct, oh yeah. Are you gonna do any whip today?
I don't know. Maybe. You know us. We usually do towards the end as we're doing the giveaway for
while we're doing the while we're giving
the
time
trove.
For people to enter the treasure trove giveaway.
Yep. It's right after right when it's the time to end the stream, which is coming up in what, about an hour? Then we will
50 minutes.
We'll give every, we have to start a different raffle for the treasure trove, and we'll go look at whip then. Want to go quite that bright on the bottom edge.
We all could hear Bella. So.
Was she over there?
Getting to be that guttural snore.
Because
she's a very happy breather.
Because the scroll has this kind of rolled edge across the top of it, and flat on the bottom, but it pooches back out, you want to give it that shadow under the roll and then a little bit of highlight down below, but not as bright as up above, right? That gives it depth. If you take a rectangle, like really this is what this is a rectangle. If you highlight the top edge really bright and you highlight the bottom edge really bright, then the whole shape loses depth. What we want to do is highlight the top really bright, keep amplifying that white up on the top of the scroll like that, and then leave the bottom edge brighter than the shadow, but dimmer than the top edge, because then you get that depth. Like the bottom edge is actually deeper on the model than the front edge, regardless if it is or not. That's just the look we're trying to achieve.
Yeah, and Zazara Death, I think he's got more than normal even today.
What's that?
Zazara Death said, is it just me, or whenever Slowfuse uses a brush, he seems to get more on his finger than on the...
Yeah, well, that's what somebody was saying earlier, right? Is that it's like I'm painting with watercolor. Yeah, because as thin as I paint, the way that I control that thinness, I like to go over on the paint. White's really hard for me to see on the palette because the palette paper is white. So I come over here after I get the paint off of the palette paper and just start painting up to my armpits, basically. I feel like this highlight is going to be a weird one and kind of push brightness in like that. Question?
See, Warboy, we've seen that one, and I don't get it.
What's that?
Why is 6 afraid of 7? because Seven is a registered sex offender. But Drizzle.
Yeah, like that's the old play on 789, right?
Well, it was, yeah. That was the original joke. So the original joke was because 789.
Yeah, I don't understand that
but
one.
But I don't get the registered sex offender. No, I get that.
I mean, I get it. I get the play on words and all that. But
I don't get how Seven is a registered sex offender.
Right, there's no story behind it. We need history. We need the history lesson. What did Seven do?
789.
That wouldn't make you a six offender.
I know.
That would make you a nine offender.
That's why I don't get that one.
That would make you a nine offender. A six offender.
Does your titanium white have a bit of a sheen to it?
Yeah, a little bit. I didn't mix in any matte varnish with it. You can. Or matte medium. You can, if you have matte medium laying around, you can put matte medium in it, and it will eliminate that. But it doesn't, because of the airbrush medium, it loses a lot of its sheen that it would have otherwise. But you can tell where it builds up, it has a little bit of a sheen. If you paint with it opaque, it definitely has a lot. Make it two. Yeah, if it were any other color other than white, I wouldn't care. Or I would change it and fix it. But because it's white, I don't care. White is oversaturating on the model anyway, the way it plays with light. So I don't really mind it being a little bit glossy, so to speak. Lighten this central edge on the thigh up just a hair. That. A bit more of a gleam line on that.
We have done three drawings. We have one more coming up.
Okay. What else? What else? What else? We got Matt. To do a little bit of something here. Mm-hmm. Feel like maybe the outside of the thigh. I don't know that there's a whole lot in here. A little bit.
Floating in a lake. Bob.
Ah, these are the guys.
Yeah.
The amputees floating in the lake. Bob.
Got them all.
Terminator symbol. Veteran symbol or whatever it is on his. Belly here.
Yeah, this is the Congress bill.
Again, much brighter
Girl
up on
Lily.
Top.
Welcome.
And then leave it in shadow Thank down below. Follow. Thank you so much for the follow. Welcome, Fred. In the middle of the belt there. Bingo. Again, I don't want to pump up too much white down low, right? Because we're trying to keep this value of everything in the shoulders. Remember, the V from the crotch to the shoulders needs to be the brightest area of the model. That's what the way we've kept it right now. Focus on the head, obviously. Right. Need to do a little something on the back of these legs before we're done. I want to finish this up so we can get adding some color if possible. Although there's not a whole lot of color on this guy, is there?
502 Bowl said, what do you use to keep your paint from drying quickly?
Faith in the Emperor.
And tiny bits of paint at a time.
Yeah, there's nothing that keeps my paint from drying. Especially being where we're at in Arizona, I'm just screwed.
Hey, somebody likes us.
Just the way it goes.
Chills.
Chills, what's happening? I work very thin, and I wind up with lots of wasted paint on my palette, unfortunately. Because it dries up, and it gets to the point where, you know, half of what I put on my palette probably isn't usable by the time I've run out of flexibility with it. Maybe not quite that bad, but.
His thumb's not his palette. His thumb is just where he.
Well, it is kind of my palette. It's no, this is
dipping,
just, this
you're
is
not
where.
Dipping your brush in your thumb to get paint. You're cleaning it off.
Yeah, this is my guarantee of the right thickness of paint that I'm painting with, right? I don't. This isn't my palette. My palette's over here. I could drag it. I would drag it out, except that it's got a bunch of shit on top of it. But yeah, I've got a big mound of white paint dried on it right now, unfortunately. Girl Lily, trust me. Wet palettes don't work in Arizona. They dry up too fast, too. They're more of a hassle because the sponge dries up and curls on the edges, and then the palette paper doesn't hold the paint the right way. It runs everywhere. Not worth it. I just don't put much paint on the palette at any given time. Wet palettes for people in places that have a, you know, kind of a 50% humidity or somewhere around there are great. They're great tools. Here, they're useless. Absolutely freaking useless.
Get down with the clown. Wow! I feel
good. Zeb, am I going to skip your message because of dad jokes? No, I just have been really doing a crappy job of paying attention to chat tonight.
I read it. He asked if you were going to do whip. I read it.
How far again do you dip your brush in the water to do the glaze effect? You just want to fill the bristles with water. I don't know about depth. I don't go very deep into the water. When I dip my brush in the water, right, here's my muddy water that we're glazing with right now. Right, and when I go in, I'm basically just, every time I clean my brush, I hit the brush at an angle to where I get about a 45 degree of a bend, and I just rub it around the edge here, and then I bring it up out. That's all I'm doing, right? And then that is completely filled with water, right, to where I get a bunch of drops of water out of it. That's all I'm doing. And I go straight to the palette with that. The key for me is that I don't go in and dip it and then, like, you know, drag it. Like, normally you would take your brush and you drag it across the top edge or like this on whatever it is to get all the water out of it. I don't do that. I literally dip it in there and then I have fully loaded with water and I go paint with that. That's how I do 99.9% of the painting you see me do, is with that type of a load on the brush.
Whoa, Pixie Lou.
But like
Thanks
I said,
for hanging out with us.
Pixie, gotta go.
Congratulations on your stream tonight.
You are lace shattered, 3 a.m. Take it easy, Pixie. Thank you so much for hanging with us. See how thin the white is, right? I mean, it's basically acting like a wash on my skin, right? It's going down into the cracks of my skin like a wash would. I mean, that's what I do, though. That's the whole feature to the way I paint is being able to pull that off, control that paint at this thickness. I'm stippling it on right now to get it to go where I want and blend with the areas around it and not just give me a bunch of hard edges. Stipple along this bottom edge. A little bit as it goes up the knee here.
He did used to have a palette cam. I think it moved to the other room.
Yeah, when we started the game room can, the cams, the palette cam had to go over there. I will be bringing another one back. I just have to get another camera. I haven't been real enthused to do so. You'll see the area right above my head has just been filled up with like the raffle text, and I've been lazy about it. We have 10 cameras on this stream when you take into account the cameras that are in the other room, and I just don't want to have to move cameras back and forth all the time. So I literally, it's just laziness. I haven't wanted to go buy another one. When you stare at 10 cameras, you're like, yeah, we don't need any more cameras for that.
But yet he's talking about adding more.
Need more. Oh no, we got to add more for the kitchen.
Yeah, well, eventually.
Yeah, well, none of that's happening now. A little bit of this scroll work setting up. We didn't do a lot of the gray on the back of the scroll there, so very, very thin white equals gray. Funny how that works.
Ray said, I find if I load the bristles, I have next to no control of the pigment. It behaves more like a wash, so I have to swipe a bit of it off before I get the kind of control you have. Is that normal, or am I doing this wrong?
No, I mean, you're seeing me doing it. I'm swiping it off on my finger so that I can bring the brush to a tip again, right? I get a pointed tip, and I think if you're doing exactly what I'm doing, then yeah, it is probably the best way to make it happen.
Not as far as Twitch notes to say.
Most of what you're doing is water anyway, so it's not like you're wasting a lot of paint. As much paint as it looks like is on my thumb, there's actually not much paint on my thumb, right? It's all thin. I mean, you can still see through all this white to the gray that was underneath, right? Except for maybe like right in the middle where I built it up a ton. I need to put a little bit more white on the palette.
Still one more name. Eventually we're gonna do cooking stream. Eventually. Don't ask when, we don't know.
That'll probably happen sooner than her painting.
No, the kitchen has to be first.
Oh, that's right. We got to finish the kitchen.
Yeah.
Oh, so that's not going to be fast. That's not going to be fast. Damn it.
Nick Van said, I need these slow fuse materials. Dice box, paint racks, and tournament box.
I know. Damn it. I need literally a cloning machine. Somebody out there get on that. Can we get one that's not near as mouthy as I am that will actually be able to do the work, though? That'd be cool. Can you make that happen? Somebody? Anybody? I'm sure I'm the last person on the planet that needs to be cloned if you get that machine made, but think about me anyway. Consider me for beta testing if you get that made.
The clones generally are not as as high of a quality as the original.
You speak from experience on this? Because I want to know who you know that has the cloning machine. You've been holding out on me.
Desire Death wants to know if this pre-highlighting trick works for a white mini or something like a camo towel.
Sure. Yeah, you would just go deeper into the whites, right? If I were painting this guy with white armor, I could use this exact same feature. I mean, you can see how the face mask will be white. I could do the whole helmet in white if I just brought lighter grays back. You wouldn't go as dark, right? The idea, if you're going to do brighter colors, is make your shadows retreat more. This guy's going to have black armor, so we don't want to have, you know, too bright, or where we do go bright, we then fall into darkness so that we can go back with a black glaze and blend it all together and make it look like black again. But if this were going to be white, we would just take this white, like on the head, back further and just have dark gray back here instead of going all the way to black. But yeah, I mean, you can use this for any color.
No, he's not going to cook. I'm going to cook. And it's not.
I love how she said that.
And it's not going to be a West Coast Eats Lab. It's going to be Jen's Kitchen.
Yeah, no, we don't. We don't. That's not the deal. That's not the goal.
Mike, are you on a phone? Or are you on a computer?
No.
He's having a hard time uploading to the Whip Gallery.
Did you register?
Oh, you got to register. He said, hold on. He said, how do I upload? Because I clicked upload now at a screen where it says upload a picture with no interface.
Okay. Oh. Unless it's broken. Try to refresh. Okay,
upload here.
Should be working.
Not authorized to upload an image. Where do I have to go to register that? So that's where he is. So where does he have to go to register?
Up at the very top of the page, it should say log in, register. Log in. Just create an account. It's basically creating a WordPress account. And you're good to go. It's not used for anything other than to make sure that people don't just come in and spam dick pics all over our site.
Which we had happen.
Yeah, but, and now at least we know where they did it from and what their IP address is, and we can go and do awful things.
Yes, from. LT, Jen's Kitchen is the bomb now. But yeah, Mike, click the login up at the top right. That'll do the trick.
His hand over here, his right hand real quick. Getting very close to having this pre-highlight done.
Before
you
logged
can see.
In, just reload, because as soon as I logged in, it popped up.
Yeah, once you've logged in, just refresh the page. It should be good to go. Same thing over here. We want a very bright contrast on this hard edge of the bracer or whatever the hell this thing is called.
He can cook, Snake Man. I'm not saying that it's impossible for a man to cook. He actually cooks quite well. He just chooses to let me do it.
Oh, the grief I'm getting right
with
now.
With the exception of breakfast. And I'm not saying anything bad. I'm saying I think it's a nice choice because I like to cook.
She does like to cook, and she's great at it, so.
I just wanted to make sure that people understood I wasn't saying that men can't cook because of the way I said Jason doesn't cook.
I'm actually a pretty good cook.
Yeah.
I don't like, I don't
breakfast.
Enjoy cooking is my
if
problem.
We, and I do, so that's why I take care of it. But when, you know, if we're going to have breakfast, he makes it.
And I don't know what it is about breakfast, but it doesn't feel as labored for me as the dinner cooking. I don't know what it is.
So yeah, so we're at the no on the dick pics right now. All right, so Desire Death said, for airbrushes, the people who ship to New Zealand offer both the Iwata Neo and the Grex with a price difference of $41. Help me pick one, please.
If the price difference is only $41, buy the Grex. Legit, buy the Grex. Because they're hosing you on the price of the Neo. Yeah, that's not even a question, in my opinion. Buy the Grex if the Grex is $40 difference. Do not stop, do not pass, go.
Mr. Dr. Banks, hello.
What's going on? Get a little bit of work done on that shoulder, or that elbow.
Maybe turn it off and turn it back on. Unplug it, plug it back in. I don't know, Mike.
What's
that?
Seems
like it should work. You can't get the upload.
Huh. That doesn't make sense. It should work. Nobody else has been complaining about it, so I don't know that the interface is down. Maybe try clearing your cache on your browser. Maybe that's a problem. Does it say you're logged in now, at least? Carry this edge of white along a little bit.
Oh, that's cool. I don't think I would want to... I like cooking at home. I even watch the cooking shows with like the home cooks, and I wouldn't even want to be stressful. Oh, Ray, that could be it. Mike, did you go through the upload already? Because it might not, it doesn't necessarily tell you. Like Ray is saying, it doesn't tell you you uploaded, it just goes blank. So if you...
Oh, it normally says you your picture has been uploaded. It takes you back to the upload
it's
screen
so
and says...
So hard to know when you can't see what... Hang on a second.
Yeah. Yeah, go back and refresh the gallery and see if your picture's there.
502 Bull wants to know if you airbrushed any of this.
Nope.
You kind of got here in the middle.
Nope. That's the whole goal. We did. The goal here was to show you how to do everything for a pre-highlight without using any airbrush, and showing the. I mean, you guys, anybody that's out there has probably already said, "Nope, I'm just going to buy an airbrush," because this is a lot harder. I've always been honest and say, "Yeah, you can do the same pre-highlight process. You can get really good results. To some extent, you can get even much better looking results, right? If you want to spend the time on it, right? We're getting a really, really nice pre-highlight on this guy, right? I feel like this is tons better than just a quick swipe with the airbrush, but this took 2 minutes and this has taken 2 hours, right? So, but we're getting more control. We're doing more of the detail work with the brush here as opposed, you know, like as far as like line highlighting, edge pop, things like that are happening as we're doing the pre-highlight. So it's not fair to compare the two directly together. You get a smoother blend with the airbrush. That's just a given. You're going to get with just a pass of white. I get grays, mid-tones, whites. I get everything. My black shadows. This is a lot quicker to get us to the point where we can start putting color on the model. This takes a lot longer to get smooth transitions, nice blends, good value on the model, things like that. But it also gives you the ability, because you're working with a brush, to do things like detailing, texturing. If I wanted to do texture on this this scroll, I can do line textures on it. You know, I get the ability to make a lot cooler things happen with the brush as I work. So, you know, I don't know that I would say that one is better than the other. It's just, how much patience do you have? Because you're seeing the kind of time it takes to go through this step. Because if I were painting an Imperial Fist right now, realize that we haven't really even started the real paint job. Now, this guy's going to be, obviously, he's a chaplain, so his armor's black.
Okay, so when I go to that page, it says choose file. And then Twitch name, any questions?
What browser are you using?
That's what I was going to ask, too.
Mike, are you using Chrome? Or like an old Firefox or something? It's built for Chrome, and it should be all cross-browser compatible, but I never guarantee that, right? You might need to try a different browser.
Chrome.
Yeah, then there's no excuse for it not working. It sucks. I don't know what to tell you, man. It's just supposed to work. Right now, like I've been saying for the past hour or so, we're just using white, very, very thin white. I'm running out of space on my skin to show you how thin it is, but just super, super thin. And we're gonna go in here and
Sneakman would like to know if you've ever changed out your needle packing bearing in your airbrush before.
Is that like blinker fluid? Mine doesn't have any of the things you're talking about. pistol grip airbrushes that aren't truly like dual action airbrushes don't have a lot of the nonsense that a dual action airbrush does, which is one of the reasons I love them. I don't have to mess with any of that crap. So I don't have all the bushings and bearings and whatever the hell you got. Muffler bearings and blinker fluid. I don't have any of that crap. Don't have to worry about it because it doesn't exist. I get to be the lazy man when I clean my airbrush. You literally take the needle out, clean the nozzle, put the needle in, spray. Done. Really, really easy.
BRB, don't get weird. Well, no promises.
Isn't it too late for
can't
that?
Can't guarantee. Well, huzzah, huzzah. I'll just throw back my legs. Knackers. My britches thank you.
Knackers. How many months is that for Knackers?
7 months in a row.
7 months. Holy hell, Knackers. Thank you so much. And again, for these highlights here, I'm basically just pulling the white from the gray towards that line, and I'm just stopping my brush in a controlled fashion to give me that line down the middle of the heel where I get that brighter white, right? So I get a nice blend from the gray with a light brush stroke and thin paint, but because the bead of paint is building up here on the back, it gives me that shine line on the heel, right? Same thing that I did kind of through the middle of the back of the greave. I'm gonna have to hit the greave, I think, with a little bit more gray because I go from like a whitish to a pure black here. I don't know why I didn't highlight these with gray, but I missed it. I blame you guys. You didn't tell me. Damn you.
To the right, just
is that right?
Perfect.
Not too much white up in here. I just want to basically lighten the gray up with just a stippling of white. Same thing up on this back of the thigh here. Kind of create, again, it's a cylinder, so it's not going to highlight very broadly. It's going to be kind of a very thin area of bright right down the length of it. So. And you don't want it to get very bright because, of course, this is all up underneath the arm and such. All right, I feel like we're looking pretty good. I don't really care about these grenades. I'm gonna paint them different colors anyway.
All right. Thank you, Leonid Lopez.
Leonid, welcome back. How the hell are you? All right. Like that's pretty good. I want a little bit more gray, so I'm gonna go back to my mid-tone gray, which was the uniform gray from War Paints. Army painter. This, if I thin down, will allow a lot of that black to show through, and we can clean up these greaves a little bit because they go from white to really, really deep black. And I don't want that contrast. It makes it look too shiny.
We will be doing one more raffle for a wheel spin. If you haven't entered yet, exclamation point booty. And then we'll also be doing our treasure trove giveaway too tonight.
Yes, indeed.
Get in on that. Well, that'll start later.
I'm just going back over that edge where my white ended, a little bit of gray, and pushing that gray a little bit further along the side of the greave than I did before to lighten it up around the curve there. That way I get a nicer blend into the black on the front, where because of the bend of the knee like that, it's going to be mostly in shadow up underneath that knee anyway, so I'm okay with that. More right along the edge here.
Hey, somebody likes us.
Three Bubba.
Hey.
78. Thank you.
Thank you so much for that follow. Over here, I dropped from white into black real quick. Kind of a no-no. Again, notice how thin my paint is. Build it up with multiple brush strokes. Go in towards the white, right along this edge of the greave as it falls into shadow there. Very quickly, kind of dull that edge of the white down a little bit.
Oh, Crusher would like to know why you didn't airbrush the pre-highlights this time.
This is particularly for the purpose of showing people that you can do this without having an airbrush.
Hey, somebody likes
That's us. All we're doing. The only reason that we're showing it with this kind of attention is so that we can show people how you can get the same kind of effect. Omega Sun, welcome. Thank you for the follow. You can get the same kind of effect. A lot of people come here and either aren't very comfortable with their airbrush skills, aren't getting the same results that we do, so they get frustrated. And even as recent as yesterday when we were painting our Suriat from Infinity, we did him with all airbrush. We did all of the pre-highlight, all of the color so far, except for the red has been done with airbrush. And then some of the metallic blacks and things that I've done with detailing have been done with a brush. But for the most part, this is about 80% airbrush right now, for all the browns especially. Right, and so to get all of our highlights and everything was all done with the pre-highlight and then a very light glaze coat of browns through the airbrush. And people were saying, can I get something similar to this? Because they thought it looks cool. It gives you a really great, quick color and value and contrast and everything that you talk about. Too sketchy. Welcome. Thank you for that follow. Great name. Can you get that same look if you don't have an airbrush or you're not ready with your airbrush skill to get to that level and you don't think that it's going to look that good? I always say don't just dive in if you don't have a good confidence in it, because the frustration that can come from hitting an airbrush on a model, even for things like pre-highlight and not getting it right, can just kind of throw you into a tailspin. Rather than do that, if you're more comfortable doing it with a brush, just realize you'll have to invest a little bit more time, but you can still get very, very good value set trying to paint, you know, basically paint a black and white model. And so that's what we're doing here. We started with just black primer. I basically did a light dusting with a white primer out of a can, a rattle can. I use the Army Painter primers, just the matte white. So we used matte white primer and just did a really light dusting. I showed people the fear that you get with the dusting because it does leave a kind of a grit or a spotting. So you have to cover all of it back up. And that's what we've been doing. Just working through from dark grays, mid-tone gray to white to get the, you know, the transitions that I've got here. So you get kind of nice highlights. You can get nice blends with it back together. Get a little bit of a metallic sheen for the armor since we're doing black armor on this guy. And set up for all of the other parts of the model that are going to need to benefit from the pre-highlight. So.
See you, Andrew. Have a good weekend.
Andrew loves Rome. Take it easy, man. You're training for some more Marines. Good on you. Take it easy. Have a great weekend. So it's really that easy. Just showing you different methods to achieve the same goal, showing you what the pitfalls are, pros and cons, so to speak, so that you can kind of say, okay, for some people watching this and saying, oh my God, this just took him 2 hours. Yeah, it looks cool, but I don't have that kind of time just to paint a Marine. Well, then you might say, okay, then the airbrush is a really great thing that you could get just to get this pre-highlight effect going. And then you can paint with a brush over the pre-highlight. You know, another stage of this is that we could have gone and done, you know, our Morat here, and we could have done him using the airbrush for the pre-highlight, and then the brush for painting and glazing all of the browns on. And it still would have given us the same kind of look, because at that point we're not relying on the airbrush for the blending of the browns anymore, because the browns are showing the blend of the pre-highlight. All of these blends on the shoulder and arm and everything are really the whites and grays and blacks that are happening underneath the color. So if you can do that, then you can brush paint in all your color if you don't feel comfortable going and doing, you know, very tight control work with your browns and all your other colors, you know, so you can kind of hybridize this solution if you want to just do your prime and your pre-highlight with your airbrush and then put the airbrush away and then do all of your color application with a brush. There's nothing wrong with that either. All of them can get you to the same point. It's just giving it's kind of a balance and trade of where is your time spent, How much patience and technique does it take to apply it? Obviously, there's a lot more technique involved with doing the brush pre-highlight that we've been working on today, because, you know, the quick spritz with the primer showed us where the light needs to fall. But now you have to be able to control, extend that, keep your shadows dark. You have to do a lot more work, whereas the airbrush kind of did it for us, right? So it's a no-brainer. So, you know, I guess kind of part of the lesson that I'm trying to teach is that an airbrush is a very, very useful tool for getting you there quicker. It's what Kenny and I say all the time. Airbrushes get you to the detail and the fun work a lot quicker and can give you much smoother transitions getting there. But, like I said, the question was asked, can you do the same thing without an airbrush? And you definitely can. I think we've shown today this is pretty much done for now, right? That our pre-highlight looks pretty good on this guy. And now we can start applying color. I want to do a little bit more white on the scroll down below, though. Before I stop completely. What time is it? How much time?
7:42.
Oh, it's about time to stop anyway. I want to brighten up a little bit on the outside of these edges. Not too much. A little bit. Here. Just to make those top rows a little brighter.
Still, one more name. I didn't go outside, so I don't.
What's that?
Really know. Has to.
Hot. I was just standing outside just to prime this guy standing out there barefoot on the concrete and was dancing.
109. Yeah, you can't go up here.
Oh my God! It was so hot.
121 on Tuesday.
Woo. Looking forward
Parker
to it.
Parker and Liz.
Looking forward to it. Anybody need a guest
here,
or a couple guests for a month? Jen and I are available if you live in a more moderate climate, you know. So there you go. You can kind of see and compare and contrast. I know this, the more it's already got color on it, but I hope you can see that by just putting a thin layer of color over this marine, look at how our value is going to set underneath. If we were to paint it the brown, we'd get very, very similar look as far as our shadows and our bright contrast as we have on the Morat, and we've never touched it with an airbrush. So again, that was the lesson. You know, hopefully you guys have been able to benefit from seeing, you know, the work with the brush. The key to what we've done today is work thin. You know, I've painted 50 million strokes of white on my finger, yep, and still this is not very, I mean, there's no thick paint. I can't like grab it and pull it off, right? Because every stroke has been that thin.
Ray, I'm sorry, I'm going to pass on Oklahoma because I've been there in the summer and it's humid. I'll take 121.
Hey, they say they'll only charge us a couple of paint jobs for room and board. Is this an ongoing thing? Like, could Jen and I have our own, like, part of the house for a couple of paint jobs? Couple of paint jobs? Because we might actually do that. Right? More heavily armed space simians. As an ad to sell airbrushes. Yeah, really, this is all just a lesson to sell airbrushes that I don't sell. So, there you go. Here's a tabletop quality squad in 3 hours show. I definitely could. Would that appeal to you guys to see me paint like a very quick, what I would, I mean, I don't do the levels of quality. So that's why that's hard for me. But as more of a challenge to me than for you guys, I mean, we could do, you know, in the course of a show you some techniques like, you know, simple base colors, washes, highlights, you know, details, and get dudes done, you know, to playable level. I could definitely do that. It's not where I thrive, you know, because I like taking, it's funny, the older I get, the more patient I am with this stuff. I know, I think that's the way things are supposed to work, right? Young people have no patience, because I know I didn't. I just wanted shit done. And the older I get, the more I'm okay with spending, you know, a dozen hours doing pre-highlight on a guy, you know, to get a really cool value and setup going, blocked in, than to just paint super fast. But love to see a quick squad.
Ooh.
All right, well, we'll do that.
Shamrock Goblin. What area are you in? Our neighbors have cable guys here all the time because of their unfortunate cutting of cable.
Guilty asks if you're still allowed to sing the air, paint, air song if you use the brush technique. And I say you can do whatever you want because it's your world and you're the king, Guilty. That's what I say. Michael, thank you so much. We're about to do another giveaway if you want to stick away before you go to bed. LT's like, yes. Ross Anante says yes. High-minded ideals on a Guardian squad and then realize it's going to be blow off the table in turn two and then just whip it out the last of it fast. See, and yeah, I just have never gotten comfortable painting that way. All my models have always been like that's... I only like to paint what I enjoy as a model, and so it all has just kind of been... Even back when I wasn't as patient, I would just get frustrated because I wanted it to look really good, but I'd paint it too fast. And so then I'd be like, oh, damn it, and I'll set it aside and redo it later. You know, nowadays I just take the time I take, and it, you know, people ask me, how long does it take you to paint a model? I'm like, I don't know, how long's a piece of string? Some models happen fast, some of them take months. I don't know, it really is for painting, usually it's a blend between how excited I am about the model, how the color scheme is working out, you know, and, you know, I guess that's it, right? But yeah, okay, we'll put it on the list of things to do, and I'll see if I can't get a squad. Unfortunately, obviously, all my commissioners right now, none of them are going to want me to paint anything in 3 hours. So as much as they'd like to have their models, nobody wants to have their model that fast. So, but we can... I've got some stuff I can build up that isn't for anything in particular. If I were to... Okay, so here's a question. If I were to paint up, say, a squad of dudes, 4 or 5 guys for, you know, Warhammer, you know, Age of Sigmar, 40K, something like that, would that be something that if we then raffled off, would people be interested in even owning that stuff? Because one of the big reasons I don't do full squads like that is because I have no reason to have them. We'll see. A generic string or a Gordian knot piece of string? I don't even know these words, Ray. Do a squad and put it on the wheel. All right. Yeah, I mean, if something can be done with a model that's beneficial for the channel, like it, you know, generates giveaways for you guys or whatever, then I'm okay with that. Yeah, all right. As long as they're Eldari, says Ross Anante. You can't discriminate what we paint. That's not the way it works. But if everybody says that, then okay. All right, yeah, I mean, we haven't done stuff like that. We've got a lot of plans for painted miniatures. Once the commissions are done around here, we're going to be doing a lot of painted miniatures, some stuff that you've already seen, miniatures as we paint on the stream that will go on to a super giveaway kind of a thing that we've got planned. We already have all the details worked out. We just need to load the thing up with painted models. But those, of course, would be done like what you see here. That would be a way to give away, like, you know, Suriots like this and full squads painted to this level. But if you guys don't mind, I mean, we can do fast stuff.
James is just saying yes to whatever.
You're saying yes to whatever. I've got you, boy. You're under my spell. G. Finnegan says, a squad of what? Yes. The answer is yes, G. Finnegan. D. Kreitzberg, holy hell, what's going on, man? Ray says, once the commissions are done, you think we're ever not going to be giving you work? See, the right answer is that you might want to give me work, but I have learned to say no. I've had to learn to say no.
Hey, all of you who just joined in, type exclamation point booty, we're about to do a giveaway.
We're about to do the last giveaway of the night, and then we're going to close it up with the final, after this giveaway is one of our Critical Mass giveaways. A spin on the wheel is coming up, and then after that we do our Friday Treasure Trove giveaway, so don't go anywhere. You have a chance to win the Treasure Trove, which is the Army Painter paint set, some cool Mini or Not miniatures, resin bases as a full kit sent anywhere in the world. So even if you don't win on this part of the giveaway, stick it out. Let's do it. We got one more to do here. Back over here to the raffle screen. We got 103 people sitting in here. We've already pulled 3 winners. This is our 4th winner of the night. Thank you guys so much for all the support that allows us to do these giveaways. It excites us. I know it excites you guys. Boy, the wheel is getting thin. I just ordered a bunch of new stuff for it. Move tech. Thank you so much for the follow. Welcome, my friend. Make sure to enter in the giveaway. You do have to be following. You do have to be here, so don't
quick,
go poop.
Quick, type exclamation.
Don't go to the bathroom. Don't go to sleep.
Anywhere.
Don't go change your kids' diapers unless you take the stream with you right now, because we're going to do a giveaway, and if you're not here, you don't get any cool stuff. So give me a drum roll. Well, let's give them a minute. We got 106, 107. We still got new people popping in here. A couple more seconds, gang.
Don't go play your piano.
Look at your shirt. Your shirt's freaking out.
I know. I look like I'm an old TV channel. That
I don't think the filter changes like when we go to different scenes. I got a thick thing. The green screen.
Hey, somebody likes us.
Jimmy boy.
107, Jimmy boy. Thank you so much for the follow. All right, we're gonna pull a winner out of this. If you haven't entered, tough luck. 108. All right, get in quick! Exclamation point, booty. We're ready? Picking a winner in the count of 10. 9.
It's different for them. It's
hey, eight. Somebody likes us.
7. 6. Stuntman Ken. Great day. Welcome to the channel, my friend. Something. 8. 7. 6. 5. 4. 3. 2. 1. All right, now it's over. Ravenous Oracle! Congrats, Ravenous! I know Ravenous is here. Because he's been typing in chat. Let us know you're here, Ravenous. He says, what? Ravenous Oracle, you're a winner. And you know what that means, right? The last of the night, but you get the awkward man stare, because that's just what we do here. So awkward man stare coming. Ravenous. You've been here, you've seen it. You know how this works. Help us spread the love to all of humanity by taking our awkward little family here and shoving it through the internet from me to you. And everyone in between is gonna feel. I guess the disclaimer is please remove small children, animals, and all family members from the room prior to partaking in the awkward man stare.
Some people are not prepared for this. You don't wanna get this.
I'd like to know what I'm thinking when I'm doing this. What, are you kidding me? All right, Ravenous, let's see what you win. Give him something good.
Big box, no way. Please.
Some tutorial time, some brushes. An hour of tutorial time, Ravenous. Congratulations. He's got the pad. I keep looking around for the pen and the pad. I like see the pen and
here,
it's throwing me off.
Trying to steal my job.
An hour of tutorial time. If you'd like to add on to that, obviously over in the store, you can book more time, but that's a free hour of time hanging out with me. What could be any better than that? So when you win that, please email me at slowfuse@slowfusegaming.com and let me know what you would like and when you would like your time slot to happen. And this goes for everybody that's won any tutorial time. We still got guys out there that have some banked. And let me know when and what you would like to discuss, and we'll handle anything you'd like to learn to paint. And we do that live. You get me on camera, one-on-one. There's nothing more awkward than that, probably. Sometimes I wear clothes, so that's a good thing. So congratulations, my friend. And then while I get that set up, let's go back, because we are going to clear that raffle. Close, reset. No winners drawn from last raffle. Are you sure you want it? Yeah, we drove 4 runners. What are you talking about? All right, what's the keyword? Did we pick one? Seems like somebody had a funny one.
We didn't have one today.
What's a keyword, guys? We have to have a funny word. Was there no funny word spoken today?
No.
Nothing?
Stroke.
Stroke is the word. And you guys just get to figure out what that means. Treasure trove. All right, for the treasure trove, none of our VIP status stuff takes any effect, so everybody has the same exact chance to win during this. I'm going to set it for 5 minutes. I'm going to set it for 8 minutes while we look at some whip. Right, and go. Bingo. Stroke is the word. Exclamation point, stroke in chat. And we are going to take a look.
Oh, it should have been rated X.
We're going to take a look at the whip gallery real quick. Do a quick refresh over there. Go to slowfusegaming.com, type !whip in chat, and it'll give you the direct link. You can go over and post what you've been working on. I have no idea who was first. I did not do my due diligence and look. Where am I supposed to start this? Anybody know? I don't know. Oh, I know I saw this on Kenny's. I know I saw a lot of this on Kenny's. I saw that on Kenny's. I don't know where I'm supposed to start. So I'm just going to start here with Ray's.
No, do that really bright.
I'm going to start here.
I like that one.
Actually, I'm going to start here because this banner looks cool,
too. I
want to
know what that is. Yeah.
This banner. G. Finnegan, a frozen corn bloodletter banner. G. Finnegan has been reviving some old corn or adding to it as well, too, with his blue demons. And I really dig this banner, man. This looks really good.
Now, is that plastic?
Yeah, this is a plastic banner, like, but fabric. I love the cracked ice and the vision of the kind of the demon in silhouette almost in the background. I really dig that, man. This is looking really good.
But it's supposed to look like fabric, right? Like
yeah.
Cloth?
Yeah, uh-huh. It yeah. Totally it's does. Like draped.
Yeah.
Yeah, but it's a plastic banner. Yeah, this is awesome. Sniper Bob got to tighten up there. I'll go back and look at it. Sniper Bob doing some vine work on your Titan. Holy hell, the freehand is real tonight, guys. Look at this.
Wow.
Look at the filigree and the vines.
That's nice.
That's really cool. I'm really digging that over the green with the teal and the turquoisey blue. That looks really good.
What is that phallic thing hanging down in the middle of your
It's
legs?
A phallic thing. It's, as Kenny calls it, it's a cock robe. Oh, Falco back. All right, cool. We'll look at the Guillemot too. I love this, man. This looks really good. I like the filigree and the vine work on the paint job. It looks very knightly. I mean, I don't mean to say that as a pun, right? It looks very, like, Knight of the Roses or something like that, right? I dig it. Very nice. Very cool. Let's go backwards then. What do we got? Gilliban from Falco Mac. New painter. Any tips to improve would be appreciated. Let's zoom in a little bit. It's a very dark picture. So the first thing I'll tell you is if you can get me something in a little bit better light, I'll be able to give you more of an idea on your colors and your contrast and value. Because with the dark picture, it's hard for me to see where you've got highlights and not. I'll tell you right now, though, your paint application looks really good. I like the fact that the gold doesn't look like it's spilling over into the blue or vice versa. So your paint looks pretty steady, pretty consistent in thickness. I'm digging it. It's a good looking model. I think
clock.
That now from here, where I would say, and again, without having a better photo, what I would say is that you are at the point where you need to start thinking about putting value on top of all of these colors so that your blue isn't the same brightness over the whole model, right? So right now you've got this good clean base coat of blue, but it's the same blue value from top to bottom, from up by his shoulders and all the way down to his feet. The blue is the same level of brightness. We call that value. And what you really want is, like we've been showing on stream tonight, everything up in the triangle form from the head and shoulders down to the belly button or crotch is usually brighter because that's exposed to your lighting source. For miniature, we usually paint with light coming from above. And so that's going to be brighter. So what you'd want to do here is try to find ways to get a little bit lighter shade of that, or lighter highlight color of that blue, mix it with maybe a little bit of a, well, I mean, for blue, there's a lot of already pre-mixed colors, and then start with glazing. But like I always say, it's those techniques that if you haven't done and you don't have a confidence in them, don't try them on a model like this because it already looks awesome. So don't go through and feel like you got to do more and then kind of mess it up or feel like, oh, it's not as cool as it was. Why did I do that? You can always do it later and practice some of these techniques on other models that aren't as big and, you know, centerpiece of your model like Guillemot is. So if you wanted to do some of your other Marines and start working on highlighting that blue up towards the top and leaving it dark down below so that you get that cool transition of color, then go back to Guillemot whenever you're comfortable with it and you can start doing it to him. Right. So, but I think that's really where you're at. Same with the golds. You can brighten up the golds on the top side, leave them a little bit darker underneath. Same with all the colors. I love the sword, though. Your flames look really good. Great start, man. Really good start. Yeah, Rossinante, right? If this is new painter stuff, you're on the right road to awesome, is all I got to say. All right. Yeah, I love the knight. Oh, better shot too. Look at that. I really dig it, man. This looks really cool. Andrew loves Rom Current. Whip from the future. Andrew went home, I think, or didn't go home, but he closed for the night. Whip from the future. Lucky bastard. He's already got his new Marines. I think I got the verification today that at least they recognize I ordered them. I didn't get a shipping notification. But they say, yeah, it's in stock, and you ordered it, and we took your money from you. So that cast account for something, right? Zeb, calling these guys done for now. Shields, assembly, then on to basing. Hell yeah. Awesome, Zeb. That's the thing, man. Like, skinks and all the stuff in Lizardmen armies, it becomes kind of a swarm army. So I really like that you've gone through and done just enough to get them to look really good on the table. And then once you get the basing on them, they should be perfect. Yeah, they should be perfect. No reason to spend a tremendous amount of time on all your little troop dudes. Finnegan's Banner, I like. This is what we're looking at. Rocinante, all three Inari types are relating paint via shape color from last Friday. Oh, nice. Yeah, very much. I remember we saw these with the hex pattern on them, right? And I'm really digging the blue that you're doing now, too, with the really bright ice blue. Looks like it even has a little bit of a green hue to it, pushing back into that really dark blue. These are phenomenal, man. I really dig the use of color on them. Because you've got that kind of rainbow spectrum stuff going on, but you haven't pushed it too far. You know, I really like the yellow to really warm and deep red, and then pushing it back into purple here. And the same with the dark blue versus the light blue and what appears to be a little bit of a green. And I can see the green on the table, so I'm going to go with yes. I'm really digging that, man. That looks really good. You say all three Inari types. Aren't there two? Aren't there just the space elves and the bad space elves? That's going to make him mad.
Oh, okay.
Ray Silver debating going with just a blue paint or going for a gray instead of black. On the pants, is that what we're talking about? I don't mind the black-blue. You could get away with glazing a little bit more of the blue into the deep recesses so that it looks a little more uniform.
I like that, too. It's so bright and pretty.
What's that?
The foil from... I think it was Rocinante.
Oh,
the bright colors.
Yeah. Dark Eldar, and Harleys. Harleys? Harlequins? They don't count. They're just the same as all the other ones with bad clothes.
Ray said there's a better lighting pick later.
All right, let's get to the better lighting pick. Is that this one? See, I don't mind the blue and the black. I feel like you could still, like I said, glaze a little bit more of the blue over the black to kind of dull the black up, bring it a little into the blue so you don't have as hard of a transition. But this is actually fairly smooth and gives it a really cool almost, I don't want to say pearlescent, but kind of, right? Where it's dark, but where the light hits it, it almost changes color. I feel like it fits the model with the colors that you've got going. I'm not mad at it. Snot Rash, great name. Still need to do highlights. I dig it. Are these from like Zombicide or Walking Dead? I dig these miniatures, man. These are awesome. These are really cool.
They do seem like Walking Dead.
Yeah, they look like Walking Dead. There's a lot of zombie board games out right now that have miniatures, and this feels like it with the hammers and the axes and the normal Joe kind of dudes. I dig it. These are neat. Bad clothes. Still one more name. Don't give away my secrets. Bad clothes equals slow fuse gaming doesn't like painting checker patterns. Damn you! You're not supposed to give away my secrets, man. Why do I pay you? Finnegan. You get your new box set tomorrow? I wish. I won't have mine for another week. I mean, I wasn't needing to do anything with it real quick anyway. But.
Walking Dead comic game.
Walking Dead, nice. Glazing highlights and realize that skinks are 8 points each, right? That's that moment of realization. That's why I don't build big swarm armies, because I just can't paint them. I spend so much time on, like, a Termagant, you know? Oh, still warm a name. Did I forget to pay you? I should get on that. Warlander says I'm an Eldar bigot. What of it, man? I like Eldar. I would actually, it'd be one of the armies that I would build. I really dig these models, man. I really dig them. The highlights, once you get your highlights in, make sure to post another picture because I feel like we're going to really enjoy the coloring. I like the kind of like the denim shirt color you got going on here with the undershirt. Really nice way of working color in and around it without it getting silly. And definitely not monotonous, too. Oh, those are the guys from the back. Yeah, definitely. Oh, yeah, they're definitely Walking Dead. I can see the guy with the, whatever his name was, with the baseball bat wrapped with barbed wire that knocked Homeboy's eye out. Was that what happened?
Smashed his whole head up. Oh, spoiler alert. Sorry.
Oops. Hang on, I'm gonna pull this back up, but I needed to get the pictures, put that back into the background a little bit. Zoom in here. I see flames. Omega Sun, first attempt at hand-drawn flames. Do you think I need a third color group besides gold and silver for this model? I really dig the silver flames on the gold. The problem is that if I don't know if you were here yesterday. We talked about color theory. One of the things that came up was value, as it does every day. But we talked about it in regard to like this hue translation that your eye does. And if you've got two colors that are at the same value as far as like they're at like, you know, full saturation or close, which metallic gold, metallic silver, we consider those to be like fully saturated paints with metallics because of the way the glare works out of the mica in the paint. So when you lay those next to each other, that line right in between them, the eye starts to blur it and it isn't as crisp as it needs to be. So the one thing I would say is find a way with maybe a black or a dark black metallic outline to go through and separate the silver and the gold from the flames, which you may be planning on doing already anyway, but I think that would then give you, then the flames stand apart silver from gold and they both those colors start to do more work for you. As far as what other color to bring in, I feel like you might be able to get away with some of this. I would say that for things like the gun barrel, I would rather see it done in like a metallic black or a darker silver, you know, more along the lines of the old bolt gun. Or something like that, or just known wash the gun, the assault cannon, the stacks on the back, so that you don't have bright silver everywhere. And then for the gold, you can go in and just start darkening it, shaded on the underside here, and work your highlights in up top. I don't think there's any reason why you can't do the whole model in golds and silvers. You're just going to need those transition colors, like a thin line of black around your flames, which I know... First time freehand in flames, you're like, what do you mean? I got to paint them again? Yeah, you kind of need to bust them apart from that gold with that black, right? Because that's really what keeps it from looking as full potential right now is that the eye, especially as people, because with metallic paints, they'll pick it up and look at it in a different light, and as that glare hits the metallic, you're going to lose your flame entirely. With that little bit of black line in between them, then you're going to remain with that shape that you've taken all the time to paint and that you really want people to respond well to and appreciate, so... Yeah, but cool. I dig it. I love the flames, man. Great work. All right, Ray Silver. Possibly better lighting to see hair glaze and pant color.
I can see blue. More blue now.
Yeah, you definitely can tell the blue is brighter. Like I said before, though, I'm not mad at it. As I look at it, because you chose this kind of a green, kind of ochre color, right? It's like a, what we would call this? It's like an olive drab, sort of, right? It's leaning a little bit more towards green than the standard brown of olive drab. But, you know, I love this color. But what it does is it allows you to play well into browns. So if you wanted to change the pant color at all, I would go into like a deep brown, maybe. You could do that. Right, like maybe a little bit browner version of this kind of orange color that you got on the gun, Ray. Right, so I think that with the olive drab, pushing the pants into brown might solve your problem. Brown is still a good neutral color. It can tend to be warm if you go too orange or too red with your brown, but I think if you kept it in kind of just a standard wood brown, that it would go good with this kind of olive drab that you've got on the packs and the accents now on the green. And then it would really just pull all that focus back to the bright greens. So you might try that. Do you have another model that has this same color scheme going on with it? Or is this the only one? Butt cheek highlights are hard to talk about. Why do you have to always tell me to ask how the model is and show me the ass? It makes me uncomfortable. I don't like painting dog wangs. You got the full set of the old Morats? Yeah, well, maybe what I would do is put this one aside now and work on another one and do brown pants on the other one and see what you like better. Honestly, I think that's your way out right there. Way out, not the way to say it, but I think that's kind of your saving grace from spending too much time fretting on it right this minute. I'll do a refresh and take a look. Looks like we got one more. We'll take a look at this, and then we'll do our giveaway. And then we're out of here. We're done with you people. My gems need work, and diamond pattern is a little loose, I think. I don't even know who you are. Who is this? Who's painting this thing? I feel like we've seen this model before, though. Not just this, obviously we've seen this model before, but I feel like we've seen this painted model before, and I don't have a problem with this in the world. But you say your gems need work, and diamond pattern is a little loose. Well, let's take a look. I like the black and white diamond
exactly,
pattern.
Exactly, light and passion. I don't like painting dog wang. Spends two whole streams painting a dog wang. This is 502 Bowl.
Hey, light and passion? Shush. Shush.
This is 502 Bowl.
Shush. 502, all right, man. I'm digging it, man. I really like the diamond pattern on the white and black. Yeah, the lines can be tightened up a little bit, but not hard to do, right? I don't feel like you've got it all out of whack. I mean, just a little bit of straightening, it looks like. So just a little bit of time there. But I really dig the colors, right? I love this purple on the black and the white. Really good color combo.
Nothing's on YouTube, Ray.
And I think the gems look really good. Yeah, I think maybe with just maybe one more on the gems, it's always tough, right? Because you can take it and you can brighten it up with a little bit more of that blue with just a skinny line, a highlight, high or low, depending on how you want the gem to shine. And then just a couple of dots of white, which I can't tell if this is gleam off of like a gloss paint or if you've actually painted that highlight on there. But it just depends on how shiny you want to make them look. Sometimes I'm a fan of them being really crystal shiny, and other times not so much. You know, I'm okay with these the way they sit. They pull out just enough of a cool blue on top of this gun to really do work. That and the nice dirty golds that you've got going on. This is a good looking model, man. Not gonna lie, I really dig it. And I love the piece of whatever the hell this is, Wraith Bone or whatever this is that he's sitting on. I dig it. Very nice. Good work, man. All right. That's all. That's all she wrote. Let's do one more giveaway. Uno mas. You don't get a wheel spin. But you do get some really, really cool crap. We have 62 people in on this. Exclamation point stroke. Your last chance. Your last chance. Last chance. I was gonna sing that, right? Last chance. I can't get that high. Damn it. Why am I a boy? 63.
Ready.
All right, drum roll. Watch right above my head in the white square. 65, Samurai named Mark. Samurai congratulations. Mark. All right, I love it. Fantastic, Samurai. You got yourself a really cool starter set of stuff. Exclamation point winner in chat so that you can get the link to show us your address. Or not show us, but go send us your address. Don't just show it to us. But the Friday Treasure Trove giveaway start off with one of the Army Painter Hobby Starter paint sets. Comes with a full set of the basic colors for the war paints that you see us use all the time. It's got a brush in it. We include another brush along with it. Two or three miniatures from Cool Mini or Not, depending on the miniature type that we send. I think these are Wrath of Kings miniatures coming your way. And resin bases for those miniatures from Elric's Hobbies or Micro Art Studios. So a really cool kit of stuff to get you going in the hobby or to accent stuff that you've already got and maybe introduce you to some new paints and miniatures along the way. So again, thank you so much to all of our partners out there. Please support them all the time. You can get all of their products over on our store at slowfusegaming.com or just anywhere on the internet. Great companies, great people, and great products that we use every day. So that's why we work with them, and they've been gracious enough to give us some cool stuff to give away every single Friday. Awesome stuff. Thank you guys so much. Hope you got a little bit out of tonight. I know that it is kind of like typical repetitive stuff, but done in a completely different manner than normal, right? So by going through and doing all of our pre-highlighting with a brush, you can see the difference that you get out of it right out of the gates because you have more control over your brushwork, more detail that you can put into your highlight. You can then decide how bright you want to push it for value, how much you're going to want to see through the next layer of color, how thin you're going to go, and get creative with it. And you get, like I said, a similar result. I hope you guys can see that all the work we did with Airbrush on our Suryat, it literally, you can get the same exact kind of feel on a model from just working it up with the brush on your pre-highlight. Our Airbrush dude. Beep, boop, beep. That's that guy. So again, thank you guys so much for hanging out with us, especially on Friday night. I know it's super late for some of you guys. Thank you so much for hanging. Thanks so much for the support and all the giveaways we were able to do tonight. The new follows, new subs, resubs. If you've been hanging out there lurking, if you're new here, real hot cats, like real hot cats. If you're here and you've been enjoying what you've seen, please hit that follow button. It keeps us going. And we will be back on Tuesday. And we will see you then. So have a wonderful weekend, guys. Don't do anything we wouldn't do.
Bye, everybody.
Remember that, right? Adios, gang. See you later.